Hello, hello, hello. Blue Kaiser here, everybody. Welcome back to Utewari Rumono, Mask of Truth. Let's see, is this the right look? Let me do a check. Yeah, close enough. Sometimes I forget. I keep on getting mixed up my YouTube, but how it goes. Yes. Why not have the opening once more? Let's double check if this is correct. There we are. Hopefully it's not too loud. I think I got the tab on deck. You always do. Welcome. Let's rewatch the opening, Bob. Let's leave you for getting the feelings this time. Oh, come on, you caught the Andrew thing. There's a lot of spoilers and foreshadowing, huh? Like this arc. And then this. I was gonna say, it feels more like foreshadowing. There's a lot of foreshadowing here! For tomorrow. Damn it, tomorrow. Now I changed the... Yeah, you can change the BGM and the title screen. And it's nice. Ooh. Now let us proceed the story. The custom is very good. Yes. Shoryun Kakor of Shorahoro. Step forward. Sir. Shoryun Kakor? Time and time again, you helped us by transporting soldiers and supplies overseas. Truly, we could not have won this war without you. Therefore, I bestow upon you the title of Minister of the Left. Oh. Minister, but not guardsman, huh? Interesting. He still has a few duties as Oshitor. It is my utmost honor, however. By order of the previous Mikado, I hold the post of a pillar general as well. I am but one man. I fear I may not be able to uphold both stations. Nonsense. I firmly believe there are none more fit for the position than you. Do you not agree, Oshitor? What do you say, my liege? Lord Shoryun Kakor's valuable experience and support are virtues not easily substituted. He's a man essential for the prosperity of Yamato. I would ask for your continued support of our league, sir. But I must hold the title of Pillar General as well. You need not worry about that. You have a splendid successor for the post, do you not? Oh no. Are you perhaps referring to... Wait, you don't mean me? A dumbfounded voice echoes through the chamber from beyond Shoryun Kakor. That is correct, Atui. I hereby appoint you to the position of Pillar General to replace Shoryun Kakor. Oh no. murmur rippled through the crowd, shocked by the appointment of a new, young Pillar General. Atri replied with clear reluctance. Oh, yikes. It's a big honor and all. I'm just not interested. But I'm sure someone else would like a shot at it, though. So could I call a pass? Oh, Ganafe. We do not need Atri in power, with authority. That's terrifying. The crowd freezes at Atui's blunt response. In the silence, Zoya and Kekor face palms hard, shaking his hair, head despairingly. Face palm, no way. But Anju, used to Anju that, but Atui's attitude by now, merely asks once more, sounding a little disappointed. What? You will not accept them? Awfully sorry, princess. Oh, I see. That's indeed disappointing. I had been hoping you could be there to support Oshitor as one of the eight pillar gen- Dang. Look at Anju making the plays. Huh? As if all that have low choice, I have no desire to force that title upon you. So what to do now? Who would stand as an equal replacement? Just not the Atui way. It is the Atui way, she's doing it for a guy though. Hey, princess? Someone who has proven themselves in battle to be worthy of one of the eight pillar generals. I mean, there's always the boy, the prince of Nokaku. What's his name? Shit! How did I ever forget his name? Glathery, help me out here! Where is it? I know if I see it, I will know it. Yeah. I don't know why. Shonen Protag! That's not his name! No. What the? Ukong? No, Ukong was Oshitor's first name. Fake off identity. Itak! Ah! Well, that's embarrassing. Okay. What is it? I'm currently deliberating, and I would appreciate your patience. What was that you said about a moment ago? Something about supporting Oshitor? Yes, as we shall be restructuring our military, Oshitor will be appointed as our High Commander. He will be responsible for leading the generals. However, this task is too taxing for Oshitor to undertake alone. That is why I wish for someone who could support him. I'll do it. I accept the position of Pillar General. Wow. How are you, Atui? Everybody sighed in relief. Atui. Atui then changed her heart, causing even more of a commotion than her refusal. Right, see? Well, I'm glad you accept the post. You can count on me. Even Kurulin looks a little happy, waving around at her side. After losing Hakuman, she's clinging on. Huh? I do not understand what just happened, but I suppose it hardly matters. Soyan Kekor, does this meet you with your approval? If Atui wishes it, I have no objections. I humbly accept my new station. Good. Umu. Umu for days. Umu for weeks. Alright, speaking of which, I should probably, do more research on when the remake of Extra is coming out. Shit. Not in satisfaction, looks to me, a sign to move on to the next one. Next, Genho of Izuura. Step forward. Sir. God, he's so spiffy! That's an awesome looking cloak! The outfit's nice too. Genho steps forward at that. Anju nods, being immersed, and announces in a resonant voice. Genho, I bestow upon you the title of Minister of the Right. I wish for you to continue supporting me with your wisdom and virtue. However, the proclamation only seems to trouble Genho. He stretches his head pensively. If you don't mind me saying, my liege, I don't recall me doing something so special as Soyan Kekor did. You need play dumb. If it weren't not for you, we could never have united to scattered plans and kept plans beneath our banner. Am I wrong? Shit, I bet he's thinking, oh no, I'm gonna lose my vacation home. I just wanted to go fishing and nap for the rest of my days. Don't do that to me! No! The reason we were so well supplied was thanks to the trust you earned among your peers. Give me far too much credit. The clan leaders gathered and the bachelor lived bachelor life. That they thought a notary was fit to be chief aim. True, I'm well aware the people of Iruha united as one. Because they thought notary to be a chief aim worthy of loyalty. But then, you think I did not notice how you made every effort to visit each clan leader to speak on behalf of your daughter? Nor that side, I've long since retired from duty. I consider the of your concerns, certainly. However, as I say, our land needs all the aid we can muster. I do not have the luxury of letting those of great ability sit idle. Lord Genho, with all respect you are due, I must ask, will you not accept this position? Sykes Almighty. A request from our liege and the Imperial Guard of the Right. Oh, well, Yamato's High Commander. I can hardly say no, can I? Kind of putting me in the spot there, you two. Assholes, I just want to vacation for the rest of my life. Genho ruffles his hair with a sigh and presses to the ground with a low bow, both fists on the floor before him. Right. What pride. If you're certain you wish to appoint me, then I humbly accept. Moo. Anju nods, pleased, and turns her gaze upon Notary, who stands before her father. And Notary, yes, my liege, I appoint you as one of the 8 Pillar Generals. I wish you and Ogi luck in restoring your house's honor. 8 Pillar General? I mean, if Hatsui can be one. What's the matter now? Don't tell me you got cold feet after all this. Father, I will be counting on your help, Notary. One day, Pillar Generals. What's the matter, dear sister? Did something get in your eye? Nonsense. Don't be silly. I'm just crying. Aww. Wait, what? I mean, that's not what I meant. I will never shed tears before our leash. You need not worry. I will allow it. My leash. Such words are wasted on the likes of me. Bambated. Aww, she's so happy. Anju waits for the crowd, murmuring to subside, and tosses the next thing. Attack of Nakoku. Step forward. Sir. Attack. Man, we're really on everybody's the 8 pillars and no concept now. Exactly. You have acted with valiance and honor in rallying troops for battle, both in Nakoku and Imperial Capital. You've served me well. Your merits are worthy of the highest praises. Now you are Owo of your own country. As Owo, I will have you bear an appropriate duty and call on betrayed and killed of all. You're ready for that? Jesus. Therefore, I appoint you as one of the 8 Pillar Generals. Thank you greatly for this honor. I humbly accept this new appointment. Is that it? What do you mean? You not have some interesting protest? Or something to add like the others? Well, not to that extent. You're just waiting for Koan, huh? To go crazy? Okay, interesting. I do expect betrayal. Oh no. Well, if you're expecting betrayal, why not attack here? I am afraid I have little else to say. Yeah, you should have started with attack. He's just too straightforward, my liege. I suggest you do not ask for the impossible. The others may misunderstand that they are obligated to entertain your audience. Oh god, there's no one in the back practicing a joke. And that uptight old man's going pale because he can't think of anything funny on the spot. Man, could you imagine getting a promotion and then everybody's like starting to crack jokes and then it's like your turn and you're like, I think. Well, attack. I look forward to your efforts. Thank you. I should put my life and soul into my work. Next, Iwaji of Emma Komori. Doesn't have the balls to betray. Step forward. Oof. As you command. Iwaji, if it weren't for your tireless support, I would not be standing here today. For all your kindness, all you've done, I am truly grateful. You saved and protected me, even though you knew such actions would bring the fire of the war to Enakmoi. What's more, I have no way of proving the truth of my claim at the time. Yet you took me in, without even a heated moment of hesitation. Because of me, many of the valiant and humble people in Makomoi lost their lives. Truly. I may never have words to convey the depths of my gratitude. Such words are wasted upon me, my liege. I only perform my natural duty as your vassal. You need not worry for my fate, my liege. Those words are all I wish to hear. Even so, I will never forget your kindness. Indeed, the kindness shown to me by all the people in Makomoi. Iwaji, I hereby appoint you as Grand Vizier, that you may continue to support me. A shocked silence followed the words, and then the crowd erupts. Iwaji himself seems to have lost words. Grand Vizier? I'm afraid. Oh god. I got a land of vibes. I fear such a grand title will be wasted on a simplistic man like myself. I can't blame it. The Grand Vizier will govern all the ministers and olds, literally the Mikado's top advisor. Technically, the position doesn't come with any real authority, but influence he will hold could sway the fate of Yamato. If I do not bestow this tower title upon you, it would set a poor example to the others. For a moment, all Iwaji can do is blink as he tries to process this. Then he kneels in dignified deference. As you wish, I, Iwaji, here swear that I shall pledge myself to your service to support you until my dying breath. I'll be counting on you for the years to come. However, I have one condition before accepting the position of Grand Vizier. Very well. Speak then. No need for modesty. What eyes dare to blink? As I leave my seat vacant, I wish for Kiru to take over my position as Enna Kamui's owl. Such was my intent. There is none more suited for the position than Oh. Oh god. Poor boy is gonna have to take care of an entire land and his people. Just give him the heart attack and be done with it. Me? It's fucked. I'm far too inexperienced. Damn, now I have no confidence that I've born 9S. What do you think? You've come to my aid. You've been saved my life again and again. Indeed, I stand here now because you continue to put your faith in me and fought alongside me. You have me believe you cannot take pride in this? That's not already. Of course not, my liege. Damn, I'm gonna come with it. Calm down. Now stand proud, Kiru. Feel the weight of all you have accomplished. All can see that you have become the sworn bow of our liege. You have stood with her through every hardship until now. Father. Kiru looks up at me for a moment more, his eyes wide, and then steps forward with clear determination. It will be an honor. I shall pledge myself for the good of Yamato, and for Enma Kamui. Good. A fine response indeed. I have high hopes for you. Thank you. And we honor those who have helped the princess on our long road to the Imperial Capital one by one. Rip. Ooh, that was Munichika for a second. It's finally over. Even Oshito. Raikou never revealed his true intentions to many. He just gathered soldiers under the claim that his princess was the rightful successor. Soon as the enemy forces realized that Raikou and his posse disappeared, they saw they had been tricked. The resistance dissolved. So ends the great war that once divided the land of Yamato. And so, my duties as well. This war took so much precious things from this country and from its people, which nation holds a problem. I'm sure they can rebuild the land of Yamato and lead it to prosperity. The truth has been restored, and now, at last, there's no more need for a man who wears a mask of deception. Yes, I think she can wait to stay where she's at, and I accept it, and you celebrated. Oh, nice ear! It's ironic, really. The person I feel closest to in the end of all this is the one that I considered my most dangerous enemy. At the very least, I wish I could have given him a proper burial. went down the mausoleum to confirm his death, and all I found there was scattered salt. The last remains of the man called Raiko. The inevitable fate of those who burned their life away on the power of the Akaruka. Konosumi crumbled away into salt, and what little remained was soon swept away by the wind. But maybe that was for the best. Maybe he'd appreciate the idea to become one with the wind and fly free in the sunlight. I spot Koan standing behind one of the pillars. I meet her gaze and she shakes her head gloomily. No sign of him either then. Mikazuchi, where have you gone? He disappeared in the midst of the battle, and ever since then, no one's seen a trace of him. Did he run from a losing battle? Him? Run? Impossible. He's the kind of guy who doesn't care when the world against him. Hell, he enjoys it. He might fight in the last stand, but he wouldn't run away. That anybody would be able to kill him, so I'm not too worried about it, but... Now that I think about it, that pillar general Lucius hasn't shown up either. Seems like he escaped by the time we arrived at the palace. Maybe he was worried we have some punishment in store and went to hiding? We made it clear that we wouldn't be punishing our once enemies. Jumping from his post, it's hard to imagine that he wasn't aware the princess was a fake. Not to mention he was following Raiko's orders. I suppose there might have been some kind of penalty for him if we were caught. Then again, I suppose I don't know much about him in the first place. Needless to say, probably shouldn't leave the matter as is. Guess we'll have to take our time searching for him. It is good. I don't know why, but Mikazuchi's disappearance, all these unanswered questions, none of it is sitting right with me. No, Neko. She knows. She knows he's gonna try to duck out. But... And so life goes back to normal. Man, it feels like a lifetime ago since we've been back in the city. An entire game ago. We're like, shit, time to wander there. Shit. Finding a horse. I'm not gonna lie. Fair amount of letters up on my table. One day, it does seem to sound nice. At the top of my table, all of them requiring responses by tonight. They start spilling on the floor by now. They've retaken the Imperial Capital, but there's still a lot of unfinished business. I'm sleeping even less than I did in my way. As usual, finish one thing and then immediately get out of 10 more. Life just isn't fair. I think I've come to see exactly why Oshitor created the Ukon persona now. Not for the fact that he needed another identity to do his job. He probably just wants some freedom. That's my take anyway. It gets so stifling. Living like this day in, day out. Paperwork. Maybe I should make myself some kind of disguise and... That's not gonna work if you can't take off your mask, Bob. I'm already playing the part of Oshitor. I don't know if I want another secret identity on top of that. Hey, if I can't get this mask off, what will be the point? Yeah, I feel like that must have hurt. My thoughts drift, and I continue writing, making sure quick brush strokes across the page. Now we're taking back the Imperial Capital when the princess will ascend the throne. My role as Oshitor should be over. About time I reveal my true identity to everyone. I step down from this seat, but leaving the seat of High Commander vacant when both Imperial Guards are gone might not be the best of ideas. Mikazuchi, what the hell are you doing? And where the hell did you go? Oh, so that's why you miss him. You want to saddle him with the job, huh? Your princess, Mikado has become a worthy ruler. She's too young. I suppose I'll be wearing this mask for a while yet. I'm fine. Then Mikado, my brother. Well, thank you. Mikazuchi was prepared to fight to the death, so that'd be pretty hard. Dare you please, huh? You appear me before me suddenly, then vanish just when it suited you. You want me to become your successor and save mankind. So with my thoughts, I barely noticed the amount of correspondence getting smaller and smaller. Suppose I've gotten a lot better at this kind of paperwork since my time in Makumori. talking about? No, he's not! He's talking his mind. Ah, well, he is talking about the Mikado, my brother. Fair enough. Once I reach a good stopping point, I rise from my seat. I open the travel case I left in the corner of the room and spread its contents on the floor. Clothes, medicine, flint and steel, rope, and other supplies for travel. I inspect each piece, checking for faults and damage, and then begin repacking the entire case. Ah. Aku was preparing us a runaway suitcase, huh? But I don't know since when, but whenever I had the time lately, I've been making preparations for our journey. This is... I stuff a small box within a larger travel case. That's nostalgic. There's the golden seal my brother gave me when I went to investigate those sea ruins in Uzurusha. So it's more like a memento now. I can't just leave them the way they are now. I'll have to keep looking for clues on how to turn them back. Not just because my brother wanted me to become a successor. There's something I want to do. Hey, brother, may I enter? Oh, Nekone. Yes, you may. I'll go with your work. Hey, brother. You must be tired, Okso. Why don't you take a break, and we can have some tea. Prepare some snacks to eat as well. Please, let yourself rest. Ah, so you were all together? Oh god, all four of them, no! Or all three of them, no! Oh no, excuse me. I'll prepare the tea now. Aku about to say, bruh, leave me alone. Here you go, alright, shall I start? Thank you. Yeah. Better? You should not push yourself so hard. Of course. I only intended on what I've left here before I sleep. Thank you for your concern, Nekone. Is something the matter, dear sister? Hey, Mushito, were you planning on going somewhere? Well, you look as though you're prepared for a long trip. Oh, I forgot to put it away. Not at this moment, no. I suppose I've simply gotten the habit of organizing my supplies from time to time. Oh no, Korra's getting ideas. Maybe. Hey, Mushito, do you remember when I asked you a while ago about going to Tuscore? Found. Oh, shit. Ah, shit. Not in front of Ruli and Nekone. Oh, I'm not saying let's go now. After everything settles down, you know? Tuscore. Well. Boy, you ready to be home, boy? Let's go, boy! The reason my brother was interested in Tuscore was because he wanted to investigate the ruins over there. He bet everything on the slightest chances, and all so he could find some way to save the humans who've been changed as the Tuscores. As his last wish, maybe that duty of investigating Tuscore now falls to me. Yes, that may be a good idea. Perhaps one day. Soon. My nod and Korin leans forward in excitement, her eyes shining. Wait, really? Aww. Oh, something the matter, Nekone. Oh. Don't worry, of course you're invited too, Nekone. Really? Do you mean that? Well, clearly, yeah. Of course I do. I want to be with all of you together forever. Poor Ruli. Nekone's face relaxes in relief after hearing Korin whisper to her kindly. Well, she wants to be with everybody, so she can just grab the whole group over. Miss Nekone. Would you like to come with us too, Rulutie? Yes, of course. Oh, so you really are close. What's the matter, dear sister? I think I smell something good from the hallway. Huh? Oshito, are you in there? I'm coming in. Oh, so this is where you all went. Perfect timing. Excuse us. Looks like everyone's turned up. All of you, what brings you here? Yeah, we were out on patrol for a while. That would bring something good back. Hot off the grill. Ah, Kokoromo. Where we used to buy these all the time from the lunch carts in the market street. Oh, this... God, I just wanted Haku to say something about this guy. Now is not the time. Many stores remain closed after the war ended, but it seems like quite a few are back in business now. This most likely meaning that the chaos is finally drawing to a close. Yes, I imagine so. We cannot claim to have retaken the Imperial capital simply because we defeated our enemies. No one's all here, it makes sense. No, he has to be Oshitor for a little while longer. It's only revealing that he's Haku when it's time for him to leave for good. When the people can return to peaceful lives they once knew, only then we can say we are the true victors. No objections there, I think. By the way, I heard them talk of Tuscore earlier. What was that all about? Oh, Felon dies, got it. Damn. Ah, yes. We were saying we should all go and visit it once things have settled down. Sounds fun. Last time we weren't exactly in a position of doing any sightseeing. It might not be a bad thing to look around once things have calmed down, yeah? Right? We leave the wonder of country. Want you all to see what all there is to see. Though we're near the side of Yamato, but there's so much I want to show you all. The fish at this port town is just so delicious, and over in the mountains they have this hot pot that uses lobster meat. They eat their horses? What would be allowed? I feel it. The thing is, who's gonna stop the Imperial Princess? Being like maybe attacked. Doubt. Wild fruits in the forest are great too, but the honey, once you get a taste, it's like you can feel your tongue melting. Oh, the Aruru freaking honey sequences. My god. You mentioned food and nothing else, I know. But there are a lot of other things, like the Yanmaruro and the Soka noodles in the west. Damn, over decapitation. Meanwhile, Koan's like, foodie tour, foodie tour, foodie tour. Then I'm getting so just listening to you talking about it, boss lady. How long has it been since we last gathered like this and chatted over food? We're like back in the old days when Oshito was still. Brother, would you like a skewer? We still have plenty left. Yes, I think I shall. Now that I think about it, the first time I met the princess, we had the same kind of skewer. I'm sure she'll be happy when she hears that the stores are opening up again. Delicious always! That vendor has improved his culinary skills at least threefold. Princess? Hello? Anju? Eh? Princess? When? Where? My liege, what are you doing here? And that's not important. Hand me another. No, not that one. That big one, just there. Yes, of course. She said, not lovely. Lowered in by a scent of skewer, perhaps. Did she smell it? Are we inside the castle? I thought that we were in Oshitor's old office. That's our liege. Our sense of smell is far beyond every citizen. Well, then again, I guess since he got promoted, he would be working the castle now, huh? He was there, that should be fine. I can finally relax now. Day in and day out, I'm plagued by nothing but baby work. Oshitor, reward me for my hard work. Here now, my leash. Did you ask? Jeez, whatever. What role, my leash? Good. Oh, yeah, about the rain. Your lap is truly the most comfortable of all thrones, Oshitor. Not gonna be shooting me that desk layer again. I guess I'll have to make it up to her later. Oh no! By the way, what were you talking about earlier? It was about Tusco, my liege. Yeah? We were all just talking about how it'd be nice to go visit Tusco once everything settles down. Tusco? I will not allow it. If I don't get to go, nobody gets to have fun! Oshitor will stay here on my side forever. Ah, for the healing. I will never give him up. Oshitor belongs to me. I found you. My liege, I did not plan on staying in Tusco forever. She planned on that flag. I merely wish to visit the land so I may broaden my horizons. That's all. I know that. She knows. But I still will not allow it. True, we may have taken the Imperial Capital, but there's still much to be done. I cannot have you vanishing on some pleasure trip. Hence why we say we'll do it after everything settles down. Not to mention, that country is insolent, princess. No. Out of the question. I mean, that situation called for drastic measures. Under different circumstances, you like her, I think. I'm sure she's a nice person. Colin's now glaring it on you. Could you imagine saying, like, oh yeah, I think me, the pretty good person, you know? What do you know, Ricorn? Well, I mean, she is the princess of my homeland. No, I still will not accept it. I'm far too busy. I cannot afford such leisure now. Alright, I'm getting it. So please calm down. Seems our travel plans have been indefinitely postponed. Ah, seems that way. Excuse me, I believe I heard our leader's voice from this room. Munechika, it has raided the room. I suspect as much to think you would abandon your royal duties to loiter here. Do not say things that may make people misunderstand. I did not abandon my duties. I was just taking a little break. I believe you promised me you would not leave the room until you examined all the documents. And if you broke our promise... Wait, just a moment, Munechika. I am the Mikado now. The almighty Mikado. You do understand what this means, do you not? You would not dare to do such a thing to the Mikado? I don't know, Anju. Munechika's face says otherwise. I will show no mercy. Shit. But I'm the Mikado. The Mikado, I say. In that moment, we are reminded, despite all that Munechika's been through and all her battles, she is still the Imperial Governess. Damn. You're not the Mikado to Munechika. And it comes to this again. Same old, same old. The road to becoming a proud, dignified Mikado is a long one indeed. Wrestle. Someone shakes my body in the darkness, pulling me out of the depths of sleep. Oh god, he's sleeping in his office? Oh, this again. Master? I apologize for coming to you at such a late hour, but you must awaken. When I have to open my blurry eyes, I find the twins staring intently in my face under the moonlight. Aye, you two. Slowly sit up, trying in vain to rub the sleep from my eyes. What's the matter? Feels like it's been a while since you woke me up like this. They pull at my sleeve, just like I remember them doing before. So where are you taking me this time? Who would even be calling for me? Pearl's already dead. Wait, is it Hanukkah? I forgot all about her with the chaos of the war. What's she doing now? Twins don't answer me, but I bowed her head in silence. And where exactly are you going? Koan enters the room, her voice raised in suspicion. Koan, what brings you to my chamber so late an hour? Where exactly are you going to take Oshitor to? Oh no. But she's so on edge. I feel like I can see something dangerous in her eyes. That saves out of the trouble. You're coming at the perfect time. We've been told to bring you as well. Huh? Me too? Yes. I'd like to know who's calling for me, I think. You will find out as soon as you can. You'll find out soon enough if you come with us. You make it sound like you know I won't refuse. That's honestly a little irritating. But I guess I am interested. Very well, let's go then. By the way, why are you still on edge? It's so on edge, Koan. I don't know what you mean. You look upon our master with a fierce emotion in your eyes. Oh no. The country still isn't quite settled. And I just figure it'd be better to be cautious than, Oh, she was gonna make her schmooze today. Seems like once again I have unknowingly caused distress. Yeah, no, go on. What I want to say is No daughtery today, said Aru and Sara. This way. We will guide you now. Please follow us. The door opens without a sound and we follow the twins out of the room. The hallway is already filled with dense cardboard. Ah, yes. So much blocking, it hurts. The hallway is already filled with dense fog obscuring our vision. Isn't this that same fog from before? Twins tugging my hand as we proceed. Watch your step. Here's a step here. Please be cautious. What did they say? Something about shifting planes? This makes it so others can't see us, I'm pretty sure. If I remember correctly, it would be disastrous if we stray too far from you. We have warned you before. You will spend eternity wandering in the world.
Ooh.
Be quiet, but tighten my grip on their hands. Walking like this reminds me of my brother will call me out on it to his place back when I was still Haku. I remember how they took me out multiple times, but only at night like this. The way ahead is blanketed in fog. We can barely tell which direction we're going. It's hard enough just to maintain our balance. Step by step, we move forward, and after a certain point, I have no idea where we are. Strange sensation. Like the rest of the world is somewhere far away, and we're just floating in the clouds. I'm guessing it's Funica that's calling for us. Oshitar, why are you looking so happy about all this? What? I'm sure you're just imagining it. Ah, back here again. Oi. Well, to be fair, in life, Haku, or the person Haku used to be from the past, the distant past, used to have a crush on good old Honoka, the wife of it. Just let the man be happy and start thinking. But then his brother got married to his crush, and things got super awkward. And then before I realized it, the ground we've been walking on has changed to green grass. We have arrived. Thank you for coming, Master. Before us is a paradise green, a safe haven, peaceful and quiet, with no trace of the ravages of war. What is this place? This is right. This is the garden my brother will always meet me in. I've been waiting for your arrival. Look around, hearing a voice nearby. Hanaka stands next to the round red table. Oh, Hanaka. Just like she always did, when my brother would greet me from his seat, smiling like she always did. Hanaka. It's quite some time since we last spoke. Wait, does that mean she knows about my real identity? Without sensing my thoughts, Hanaka closed her eyes, giving me the slightest of nods. I see. She must have heard it from the twins. That's fine, though. I'm just glad she's okay. And thank you for joining us at such a late hour, Lady Koan. Well, what exactly have you... Why is that? There, I have too many questions. I can't think straight. Oshitar, please, will you not first seat yourself? Very well. She gestures towards the table and takes a seat opposite Hanaka. Enjoy. We have prepared you some tea. I have no idea when they prepared it, but the twins offered me a cup of hot tea. Please enjoy before it gets cold. Yes, my thanks. The cup's contents are clear yet faintly green, a gentle stream and steam rises from the surface. One sip and a refreshing fragrance filled my mouth, with a slight bitterness remaining on my tongue. This taste. I have not had it for some time. I do enjoy Yamatan tea, the kind made from boiling fermented tea leaves. I definitely prefer green tea over it. This is green tea. Something the matter? You still make the same face when you enjoy your tea. Is that so? Never know how to act in front of her. It's good. Excellent green tea, too, you know. In any case, I'm glad that Hanaka's alright. Oshitar, you're grinning like a fool. Oh no. There's so much I want to ask her, but for now, I could slow down and enjoy this moment of peace. So where exactly is this place? Koan asks as she looks around. The garden deep beneath the surface of the Imperial Capital. Let my man enjoy life. A garden beneath the surface? You mean we're underground? But... Koan points up in the sky. Jesus fuck. Thousands of stars glinter above us. Hanaka does not say anything, merely smiles back in Koan. Wait a minute, is this place? Yes, it is, just as you think. There's still something of this scale left? Then why did you bring me here? Shouldn't any outsiders be forbidden to enter a place like this? It does not matter, whether you know of its existence or not. You'll never be able to reach it without guidance. I'm sure I do not need to clarify further. Are you saying? Koan stops and says, I would like to formally offer my thanks to the both of you. Hanaka stands, the conversation drawing to a close. She bows deeply. My daughters have told me stories of the path you walked. Thank you for supporting that child, Anju. And thank you for taking back the land of Yamato. I can only imagine all you must have endured. I'm truly grateful. It would not have been possible without the help of my friends and allies. I never would have been able to see it through alone. But you were forced to throw everything away for this. Even what little proof you kept of your own existence. That was my decision to make. And can I have you blame yourself for that, Monica? I can feel Cohen's eyes on me. Probably not a good idea to talk about this. Better change the subject. I do hope these two were of use to you. Perfectly. We have done a flawless job. From death till dawn. Oi. We're especially proud of our service at dusk. Oi. It's good to hear that you're doing well. Truly, I am relieved. Wait, you are. Oi. Oh no. Cohen's eyes are boring into me. In any case, I believe I'm due some answers. What exactly happened? That is my question. That is... She hesitates, an uneasy silence passes between us, and she means that at a loss of words. I believe it would be best for you to hear from him directly. Him? Please follow me. It appears he has awoken. He turns around and walks deeper into the bath garden. This bashed night from Mom and Twin Dot. Damn. I mean, he could be. Who does she... Though I'm puzzled by Hanako's words I follow, who else could he be? Finally, we reach a small tower, unremarkable, amidst their surrounding green and far from well kept. At first glance, I can see any windows or even any cracks in the material to indicate a door, just walls on all sides. Mary and Sarah have come here before. This was their entrance to... I've brought them. As a response to her voice, a faint seam opens on the door and slowly reveals in our entryway. What? The only person who could be able to open that doorway is my brother. Wait, he can't be. No, impossible. He's dead. The sealed gates. No. Yes. Cohen mutters in awe as she recognizes something. No. Yes. We cross the threshold. A light illuminates the hallway as we take a couple steps inside. Our brother. Haku, brother. Amazing, this place looks practically untouched. I've never seen anything like it. But it's all still functional. With not a trace of deterioration or weathering. I thought even the Onkami Yonkai have something like this. Why would you come to a dead end in the hallway? Go on, you might... Huh? You may feel some nausea, please be warned. Suddenly, we're all struck by a feeling of floating upwards. From one of my innards lurch as we plunge down at an immense speed. Startled, Cohen lets an undignified yelp as she strangled to steady herself. Then poker faces as if nothing happened. Can't hold it back, thanks to her little lapse in composure, I failed to stifle a laugh at her expense. Whack, whack. She's noticed, she's whacked me with her tail, her face bright red. You two certainly seem close. It's not. I'm not. Only natural, Cohen's a very special woman to me. Oi. After all, she is my friend and comrade, who has stood with me through countless hardships. Oh no. Friend zone. Oh, oh no. Oh, oh god. No. Even Aru and Saran are cringing. Instead of, I noticed the twins giving a silent, victorious fist bump for some reason. Now she's hitting me even harder. What? No. Why? So... the thing gradually slows until we come to a complete stop. I want to feed a fence and fist bump. The next room is dimly lit. We have a faint illumination in the walls and floors to go by. A little rumbling noise echoes throughout the room. I have returned, my lord. Your lord? Hanako smiles as peaceful as ever. I can't even tell if she's aware of my surprise. And then a voice echoes, not in my ears, but in my head. It's weak, but I know instantly who it is. Someone I thought I'd never hear from again. In a flash of light, the dark room is revealed. No, yes. Why? Because... Technology! Countless wires, someone as thick as my arm, stretched towards the center of the room, and sitting there, connected to all of them, a massive jar sits, low, more like a capsule, shaped almost like a light bulb. I stepped forward to the center of the room, as I hear the voice. The capsule filled with a slightly discolored liquid. That pervy old man, and floating inside, is that very pervy old man. Here you go. Ew. Hey, the Mikado. Been quite a while. Hey, Nikis. Yeah. The Mikado's eyes flicker open. I see a weak smile on his face. Bro. Bro. You don't mean you were alive. Beyond that, I'm speechless. My mind races. My emotions can't keep up with my thoughts. Naruta, I see you make a face like that. A rare treat indeed. As you can see, I've managed to survive. Survive? Yeah, sure, he's alive. But what was all that equipment? The dignified old man I remember is gone. The man floating limply before me looks like some kind of shriveled fish, half dead in the water. Seems I've caused much trouble for you. With that, I am sorry. But I can only give my heartfelt praise for protecting my daughter until now. Thank you. If anyone deserves thanks, it should be him, not me. Not for his wish. I can't imagine I would have ever gotten this far. I see. So, another man of virtue dead. That is a truly grave loss. He was a man worthy of bearing the burden that is Yamato. Both him and his father. It seems like good men always go first, leaving me behind. My lord. I had no idea my brother had such high hopes for Oshitori. Wish he was still here, so I can tell him about it. No wonder you're still around. Look at you, what happened? How did you end up like this? You're not worried, it's nothing serious. Someone attacked me in the middle of my procedures to prolong my life. You're not a good man. And so I'm left in a sorry state, because I was ambushed while my protective barrier was lowered. You were attacked? By who? Was it Raikou? No. Damn it now, calm down! That makes no sense, timing-wise, and besides, his actions, his loyalty to my brother was practically as fierce as your eyes. I imagine him ever desperate enough to orchestrate an assassination, but in that case... I do not know. It all happened so suddenly. My memory is still all blur. Tui said on you. Goddamn. I went to photo assassin. I left a false body behind and hid my wounded body to recover. That's all I can remember. I remember nothing else. You were attacked in such a secluded space. The culprit must have been someone close to you. But who in the world? He knows. As you can see, my body went stasis, and by the time I regained consciousness, it was all over. And you there. Me? Your name was Kuon, was it not? Or rather, I should say, Lady Kuon. I have heard quite a bit about you. The reason I write you as well is because I wish to extend my thanks. Not for your help, my daughter. I know everything about it. How you cheered her on, supported her, and helped her. Not as the Mikado, but as her father. Allow me to say, thank you. And so, I owe you an apology, for my command, for the invasion of your homeland. I can only apologize for taking so many precious things from you. Why? Why to score? I never understood it. This country of Yamato is so prosperous. No, even too prosperous. Can't imagine any reason you would need to invade another country. So why? It was a selfish decision of mine. A selfish decision I made as a human being. I will tell you the truth of the matter from the beginning. I'm sure you have realized it by now, the truth of what I really am. Onbitaikayan. Yes, I am one of those beings you call the Onbitaikayan. The ones who once ruled this world, the ones who succumbed to hubris, the self-styled gods of creation, they eventually caused their own downfall. I was the sole survivor. Bro. Long, long ago, there was a calamity. The heavens exploded with thunderous roars. The very land split and cracked. The oceans raged. Indeed, our world itself howled in pain. It was as though the world was coming to an end. No, it was truly an apocalypse. I was barely able to survive, and when the dust had cleared, and I looked around, I realized I was the only one left. You know the fate of the other Unriakan, do you not? It's indeed true. This is what is left of the human race. That's right. The Unkami. So, there's many of them. So dry, Kohan smiles at breath at the sight beyond any of her expectations. I wish to save my brethren. Your papa do it, didn't do so. Yes, indeed. I was continuing my research, hoping I would uncover some way to revert them. I sought the clues I lacked and eliminate all who stood in my... To be fair, even though they censored it, I look back. Apparently, their daughter also did not make it. Maybe? It's kind of vague. You, those who have sworn their loyalty, I laid claim to the ruins and conquered the nations around me to bring them under my control. Like, straight up got dissected. So yeah, kinda. And eventually, after subjugating absorbing so many lesser countries, my land came to be known as Yamato. Did I know how much time has passed since then? My research could only move so slowly. Only salvation I found for them was annihilation. Yet if I use such destructive power, it will sacrifice too far too many of my people. I have grown far too old to go through with such atrocity. Ah, so the only other option was to kill with humanity, but it will ruin. Eventually, the resolve of women crumbled down over the years until only despair was left. And then, when all was beyond hope, I found my long-lost brother, Hiroshi. Wait, we should not be discussing... He keeps going, he's gonna blow my cover. Wait a minute, who the hell are you calling Hiroshi? Oh no, perhaps it was Yuji? Damn it, he really forgot his own brother's name. To be fair, it was only, apparently it's been 3,000 years, so... Shit, Bob. Wait. What do you mean, brother? Come on, don't play dumb. Are you saying that Oshitor isn't really Oshitor? My lady, you figured this shit out so long ago. I guess she just really wants to force him to say it, huh? Come. Is she? Do you think it's not time for you to take off that mask? To shed the name of Oshitor? She wants to hear it from him, huh? It is you. Aye, finally.
Buddy. Yeah, buddy.
Haku. Makata did something for good. It's like, why are you putting around here? There's no one else to listen to this. You can be you. God damn it, man.
Haku.
That won't go. No, you are wrong. Huh? I am Oshitor. Oshitor in the power card to the right. Haku. It's gone. That can't be. You're Haku. I know you're Haku. Why? You've done your job, haven't you? It should be fine if Haku comes back now. No, it won't be right. The dead cannot be resurrected. That would be an insult to the name I have taken. More than that, Akaruka. This has fused itself to me. I cannot remove it. No. On that day, Haku dies. You must understand. I can't. How can I? Aww. You are the one we cannot understand. Why are you so fixated on this? Is the name Haku that important to you? Our master is our master. A difference in name is no difference at all. You. Ooh, that's an oof for me, Bob. That's a big oof. It's an interesting dilemma. I apologize for my daughter's behavior. The Akaruka was originally created for us, after all. For humankind. Once it's fused, it cannot be removed. But aware of his own safety. I'm truly sorry. I had no idea what he meant to you. And now, once more, seems I've taken something precious from you. Oh. Fine. Sick. The wild Kawan stares downward, her face unreadable. Then she smacks both palms against her cheeks, pulling close together. I did not really agree with the decision, but I'll accept it. For now. Take it from me. Yeah. But I fully expect you to explain everything. I'm not taking no for an answer. Go on, you put two and two together. Come on, it's not that hard to figure out. Right. So, Sir Mikado? Could you please return to me? Oh, quite a bold girl, isn't she? I'm being as reasonable as I can, thank you. Let me be clear, if you weren't in the state you are in, I would have slammed my face into your face seconds ago. Don't think I wouldn't. Yes. If Haku doesn't break, I swear my life. You needn't glare at me like that. This girl. She's apparently a scary one. Hiroshi, I didn't know this was getting tight. Bob. The popular internet has proven to everybody that sometimes you just want to be dominated. Rather than evil village anyone. How many times did I have to say my name isn't Hiroshi? And what the hell was he even talking about? Nothing. It was nothing. Well, allow me to continue then. My long-lost brother appeared before me, now called Haku, a new name he had donned. I knew this had to be some kind of sign. I could sense I did not have much longer to live. Say, do you remember what I said to you before? I shall leave this country to Anju, but I have my legacy. The legacy of the human race must follow you. And then at last, I may share my burdens. So Haku was Mikado's. But before I could pass my duties on to him, there was something I had to do. That's why you invaded Tuscor? I don't know if I call that a good reason. The Master Key. It was some decades ago, I believe. I found a signal within your country of Tuscor. A signal that belonged to the Master Key. Do you remember from the first game? The time we used the Master Key. Eru used it to open the door. So what is this Master Key? A key indeed to everything. With that key, one may restore life to these ancient facilities. These ruins will hum with power and purpose once more. Ah, so he doesn't have administrative purposes. Or administrative privileges, rather. If I can only acquire this key, I thought. Perhaps they are able to unlock some way to save my brother at... So you managed to do this much with only a student user key, huh? Damn, that's actually kind of impressive. That's what I believed. I feared I'd succumb to old age before I complete my task. I gave up, thinking it was too late. However, fuck that, don't bring back humanity. If you would accept this duty, my steed. Unfortunately, his choice was to either find a way to bring them back, or use the weather satellite. Here, it'd be just a sin. That's not a bad reasoning, Bob, but I think one of the reasons why he couldn't kill them all off is because it would require the weather satellite. And if he did that, well, Yamato would be fucked. And he just did not have it in him to just do all that killing and then making his people suffer. And it's just like, I don't want to do it anymore, Bob. It's just... There will come a day when the Master Key will prove vital to your efforts. Such was my belief. After they create Cole, you're like Cole and after third green shit. Oh yeah, that's a big nah for me. For him, it's like, you can't just leave him in there. After my brother finishes, a heavy silence envelops the room. Because, not just letting you know all the things. We're going to try changing the subject. The problem is that Jilly will eventually, like these machines that he's keeping, the giant group of them in, will eventually break down. So he has to do something about them. He can't exactly let them go. And he doesn't have it in him to blow them up. So it's like, he was in a rush. That's one thing I'm curious about. Yes, what would that be? What exactly is the Akaruka? Oshtar can metamorphose a person's body into a horrifically powerful creature almost instantly. Wait, all this technology? Yes. He'll eventually run out of energy, right? Especially if there's no humans to maintain it. It may be the Mikado, but I can't imagine you accomplishing that through technology alone. Why not sink to the bottom of the ocean? What exactly is that thing? The Akaruka, the power of origin. That's right, I forgot about it. Well, with everything else, but I wondered how that kind of power could exist. He would have to find a way to move them to the bottom of the ocean first, Bob. Are you familiar with the endeavor called as the True Humanity Project? No need for energy or anything? Perhaps, but here's the thing though, they are immortal, so they could survive. We have God math. True Humanity? Do I remember? That's the project he poured his life into, the last hope to save humanity from extinction. And what about the Iceman project? Iceman? No, I do not think. Wait a minute, where have I? Wait, that was the offshoot project from the True Humanity Project, the one those researchers were so obsessed with. The Iceman project was derived from the True Humanity Project. It's through their efforts that the Akaruka were created. They employed a different method than what I had envisioned, but it was intended to strengthen our weak human bodies. Oh no. So that we may survive, Akuro. Yeah. These masks we've been using have been Nerf brand imitation Akuro masks. Then, I suppose there's no use of speaking of it now. Back when Yamato was still a much smaller country, I worried for our small military and saw a solution in Akarukas. A simple way to empower the soldier who donned it. Unfortunately, part of relevant data has been corrupted by that point. I attempted to make up for it with my own research and create my own version of the mask. Wait, was that really the best idea? I convinced myself I was, I suppose. I had run all kinds of tests to ensure its safety, and all my theories indicated that it would be flawless. I was so confident in my creation. So I bestowed the Akaruka upon our worthy warrior. However, my lord, so it was a failure then. It was far too powerful. The unlucky bearer was consumed and drained of his sanity. They became an abomination, rampaging, causing death and disaster wherever it went. Ah, that was the prototype mask Raikou used. This has such a power was beyond the capabilities of technology, and indeed you are correct. Such a thing should have been impossible. It was a power beyond any of my projections. A power that should have never ever existed. The power of the Akaruka is more of a side effect more than anything else. I wanted me to find some way to stop the rampage, but its power was far too great. No one could stop it. Not I, nor anyone else. I had no choice. I knew I was only repeating my mistakes, but I created beings that could stand against it. I created more Akarukas. I have divided its power into four, and made sure to place a limiter within to control its might. Four, into this. Such math upon my face. The fight lasted many days, and though it took great sacrifice at last, the battle came to an end. In the end, that warrior, the bearer of the first Akaruka, their body could not handle the strain. In the end, they were disintegrated. Other four bearers of the lesser Akarukas used up all their strength in that battle. None returned. All of them. Such fine young warriors. Yes, that's right. They called me their father, you know? A fool like myself. You didn't steal away the Akarukas? I know firsthand how much power they have, but I'm sure you could have managed without them. How could I deny the lies of those who believed in me? Those who sacrificed themselves for me. Some say the Akarukas are symbols of Yamato's power, but that is not correct. They serve to remind me of my foolishness. Bro. Damn, I was hoping I'd lighten the mood a bit, but I just got even heavier in here. In any case, I'm glad you're still alive. Your princess will be overjoyed. You're probably right. We should probably tell her the good news when we get back. No. You must not tell her. What do you mean? Alright, I am a man long dead. and you have confronted my death and moved past it. Indeed, she could not have come this far otherwise. If she learns that I still live, I have no doubt she'll wish to rely on me once more. What are you talking about? What's wrong with a child relying on their parent? Certainly an ordinary child will be allowed. However, she is now the Mikado. My daughter, Anju, must carry the burden of the people as the new Mikado. You of all people should know that she cannot be seen to rely so heavily on another. I will be nothing but hindrance to her. Bro, if I'm in this condition, he's probably not in the best emotional state either. I wish there was some way I could cheer him up. Fine then. You need the Masaki, huh? If it's somewhere in Tusca, I'll track it down for you somehow. So cheer up. Don't give me the stuff about you being a hindrance. It's too early to go about talking like you're some kind of gloomy shut-in. Oh, so you go over me. I could have never imagined the day you'd come. Wherein you would lecture me for being a shut-in. There'd be no problem. I was planning on going there anyway. Just speed things up a bit. Don't get your hopes up though, okay? This score is a huge place, and I don't have a clue where to start. You need not rush things. You have plenty of time to spend if you see fit. And I guess I'll make a little visit. We shall guide you. What are you two saying? I should be the one doing the guiding. Not necessary. Please, we can handle all the matters of guidance, or attending to our master's daily needs. I'm going. I don't care what you have to say. It's my homeland, isn't it? Master Key. Or that I'd be heading back to that country for something like this? We're going back, boys. We're going back to 2 score. Wait. No. What an unusually dense fog. Right, calling from Bones. Lord Wutus. What is it? We have observed an attempt at contact. Any doubt so? About time he made his move. Wutus. Are you sure they haven't noticed our efforts? Yes, I believe they have not noticed us. Very good. But where exactly are they hiding? We only had the approximate idea of their location, but we live somewhere far beneath the Imperial Capital Palace. But that's where the nest is. If you had just remained silent, you might have escaped all of this. But now I've finally found you, father. There's one more thing I would like to report. And that is? This information comes from one of the spies that's been keeping an eye on Oshitor. The meaning of this? How do you manage to reach that site? Leave early. I want a detailed report. Yes, sir. My report is as follows. Father. Father. I see, then that's how it is. Wutus's hand clenches in a shaking fist, and icy tension fills the room. Lord Wutus. Though he still lives. Dear brother, where has he slipped off to now? Almost sunrise, and his bed is empty. Oh, welcome back, dear brother. Why was Wutus trying to assassinate Haku? Oh, you will see. There you are. Dear sister? What are you doing in such an hour? I'm so sorry. I can understand Haku, but Wutus. No, you needn't worry, I was merely surprised. If you have to come to talk to your brother, he is currently asleep. If you'd like me to relay your message, I can. She's lying. You've been supporting him like this all this time. Wow, my brain died. Take a second to relax. Wutus says that his father still lives. He must have had no idea how to handle all of this, and must have felt so out of place. And still, he decided to fight for this world that he doesn't even recognize. Of course, you three stood together. You must have been so worried. And I doubt you had even a moment of respite. Plus, I'm assuming that Oshitor, talked to her about it on the way out, because she didn't want an explanation. Dear sister, I'm afraid I do not quite understand your meaning. Juan quietly steps closer. Pulling Nekone to her a gentle embrace. Well, it's alright now. Oshitor. No. Haku told me everything. Everything you've been through till now. Violent shadow ripples through Nakone's body as she suppressed the cast.
It
must have been so hard on you. You left to feel so much pain, so much sadness. It was so much for you to bear. I'm so sorry. I can't see it, Dad. I'm so sorry. I left you all on your own. Yeah, Cohen, you suck. Nakone's body goes limp in Cohen's arms as tears stream down her cheeks. I'm sorry. It was all my fault. Imagine if we get that out through her sobbing. It was my fault, but what are you? You had your lost his life. And Haku, for me, for everyone. For Emma Kamui, gave up his life to live someone else's. And robbed him of his future. I'm so sorry. Your mother felt such pain when we told you Haku was dead. Haku must have felt such pain watching you leave. I knew everything. I chose to keep you off. Well, of course she had an idea. Literally walked away. Left to broke Haku's heart. Lying to everyone to play my dear brother's role. I've felt so much pain with so much people. It is all my fault. Aww, that's not true. It's not your fault, Nakone. I'm sure Haku will say the same thing. You didn't force him into that role. It was a decision he made on his own. So you don't need to blame yourself for all this. Haku chose to defy fate. He carried on Oshitori's will and intends to carry out his will until the very end. But I was the one who took Haku from you. We can now return to the way things used to be. We can't go back the way we were. But Haku's not dead yet. You may act that way, but there are moments where I can see it's still Haku in there. And that's all I really need. But the one who was hurting the most was always you, wasn't it, Nakone? You lost Oshitori and blamed yourself. But you still protected us all. That's why. I want you to promise me you won't blame yourself for this anymore. I want you to know. You can't blame Nakone when no one wrong. Yeah, God, Nakone is strong and I don't care what to do. You know how much Oshitori cared for you? You know he will never want you to carry this pain. I'm so sorry. She showed her the one that in this here. Oh dear God, come now. I just asked you to promise me. Please. Let me apologize too. I won't let you feel alone anymore, Nakone. Nakone sobs against their family giving in. Kon only holds her tighter with as much kindness and love as she can convey. That's why I want Haku called out. Well, they needed to build up, and wasn't it worth it? Isn't the moon just lazily in the sky, bathing the two in its light? Not for him, but for the poor girl. Imagine making me sniffle, fade, and torn, stroke her hair for a moment more, and close to a stop, feeling her calm down. She speaks gently. Hello, Nekone. Some poor British. Why don't you come to Tosco with us? Oshitar and I have to head to Tosco for some important business. You should come too, Nekone. It would be good to have some time to relax, I think. I don't think anyone over there would be concerned with Oshitar's identity. Sure, you'll be able to take it easy while you're there. Dear sister, thank you for your concern. Definitely a TG. I really could have used a TG. But I must have. Just decline. Please go without me, just the two of you. Why? I would like for you to reclaim the time I have taken from you. Time of Hawker. Nekone, you're such a kind girl, but... Please, just the two of you. But Kwan seems reluctant to leave Nekone behind, but faced with the girl's earnest, pleading eyes, she gives in. Alright. You have a nice rest then, Nekone. I can take over as a babysitter for a while, I think.
Yes.
Thank you there, sister. You look best when you smile, Nekone. Kwon smiles at sigh in relief. Aren't we dropping the Yamato crew for the Tosco crew? Maybe. However faint and however brief, Nekone finally smiling again. Damn, she hasn't been able to smile? Oh, come on! She had that moment! We took Nekone away. Same! We need more Nekone content. She needed more. No one to say else. Way anchor. Plus it wouldn't even really be those two. I'm pretty sure the twins are coming with. The Rankless voices sound across the deck as we leave the harbor. Seems like I considered her their younger sibling, yeah. Never thought to see a gal wandering off on a secret mission. You're seriously caught out of breath from the war. Imagine you'd be staying on Allegia's side for a while yet. Considering the vital task, one I cannot leave to another, thus I decide to go in person. I must ask that you keep this quiet as well. Why don't you assist it that much? I expect it's quite an important calling. I'll not pester you about it. From here on out of my realm, you just sit back and put your lordly feet up and enjoy the ride. Strange. What's my sister? I see a very mother daughter relationship. Suppose. My sincere gratitude. I'm extremely fortunate for me that you still remained in the Imperial capital, Lord Zoyan Kekkon. Yes, I was just escorting some merchant ships to the Omochako River. Rest assured, if this land's reachable, I see. I can get you there. With that, Zoyan Kekkon strides up to the ship's bow to command his crew. Carried by the wind, the ship begins picking up speed as it glides over the water. After reuniting with my brother, I debated myself how to go about this and decided to head out on my own. Good thing I had prepared for a while to leave on short notice. Not that I was running away, I just wanted some time alone to cool my head. Didn't tell anyone was leaving, but I left a note behind so they wouldn't be too worried. I don't even know where to start to search for this master key. Yeah, he's gonna go dancing around the country for a month. For now, I think I'll just enjoy a peaceful trip. Man, that letter is gonna leave them pissed. So it's getting a bit dry. Maybe I'll go get a rintan. Stuff for the detective. Wait, tea. Oh, why thank you. Huh? You're very welcome. We should have just taken Nekone with us. God damn it, Lady Fumaro. Yes? Why are you... Yes? Why are you here? Why do you ask? Well, because I'm Ku's caretaker. God damn, I wish we had Nekone. Caretaker, wait, then that would mean... Slowly my gaze turns to where Fumaro is looking. Oh. The escape has failed. Mission failed. We'll get them next time. The person standing there had a wide smile on her face, but I can clearly see a vein throbbing in her forehead. A shiver runs down my spine. Come on. Yay, now that I remember, yeah. Now I'd like to know exactly why you left without telling anyone. But maybe, yeah. Not telling anyone, I think. What the fuck, go on. She doesn't know what you mean. If you want to insist on it, maybe you should go fight her now. I'm sure you can win. You sound calm, but her smile definitely doesn't reach your eyes. Wait, it's not quite as if I didn't tell anyone. Oi. Won't you suggesting that you're no excuse of this, are you? That's not good. She looks like she's really pissed about this. After we have prepared your meal. We should've just brought Nekome, goddammit. She could've used a vacation. Now that we brought an entire circus with us. Wait, what are you two doing here? Silly question. Our place is always by beside our master. Asking for a reason is meaningless. And? We haven't finished talking about everything yet. And well, we did ditch the Amatoku. Yeah, but Nekone, goddammit. There's still a lot of people around. I can't let her talk about that stuff here. Lunch for her, covering Koan's mouth with my hand. Ow. That was not a gentle bite. Dude, that's not very good manners. More importantly, Master, it's bad for your health to remain in strong sunlight at the sea. We've prepared a shaded area. Come and sit. Hey. Twins each grab an arm, and I'm forced to walk with him. Hey, what do you mean more importantly? Where do you think you're taking him? I hear Koan yelling behind me as I'm guided to the back of the deck. Looks like they prepare a large umbrella with a cloth mat laid out underneath it. Top of the mat is a beautiful glass bowl filled with rintans chilling in ice. The sight alone is about to, enough to make you feel refreshed. The twins lift one from the bowl, open a hole from the side, pouring its contents to a cup. Nice and cold. We've chilled the rintan for you. Should be perfect temperature. This is bound to taste really good. I should say I'm just thirsty. But Koan's staring. Kinda makes me feel guilty. I know, Koan, why not come join us? It should really be better to have a nice chat while sitting down, yes? Trying to change the subject again. Oh man. Be our guest, Comrade Fumario. We welcome you with open arms. Don't worry. Allow me to pour you some as well. Alright, thank you. Quick up, I down the contents of my cup so Fumario can pour me some. As the liquor splashes onto my cup, I feel something soft pressing against my arm. Why she always is oblivious. But man, that feels nice. Wait, what? So Comrade Fumi, wait, what the? Behind me, see the twins rubbing my back and legs as if to compete with her. Oh yeah, this is paradise. Ah, it's true. For a moment, I'm lost and relaxing, tiny but God damn it. Oh, it feels like I'm just gonna melt away. Wait a minute, it feels like I'm forgetting something. Oh, you stupid. I kill for this. I feel like a lot of people wouldn't, man. You know, except for the whole Koan giving you the murder stare. No bit here. Of course you would. Koan, except for, you know, it'd still be worth. Man, you're brave. Watch out the whole thing killing daggers. Somehow her icy stare is even more chilling than the rintan juice was. Haven turns to night as everyone else starts heading to bed. I make my way onto the deck alone. Watch the water flowing up when I wake. The way that cries tonight, staring at the sea, I let my mind wander. Need a plan. What's my first move when I arrive in fifth floor? Such a rush to leave, I didn't really think of the future. Probably come up with some kind of plan now. If I'm gathering my thoughts, I hear footsteps behind me. Go on. I'm sorry. Huh? I can no longer return to being Haku. I see. Trusting you, so if she can punch me, I'll be fine. If you just have to... I don't think it's the punching that's the problem. It's the her tail turning your head into an hourglass that might be the issue. We cannot know who could be listening. You must never call me Haku. Ever. I understand. Sorry that you must go do this, but thank you. We stand silent for a while. The waves seem louder than they did a moment ago. But what do you intend on doing from now on? Question is quiet. I promised my brother I'd find a master key, so... Not that. Do you still intend on upholding Ochitori's legacy? Or are you going to take over as the Mikado's legacy instead? No, when time comes and Oshito is no longer needed, I think I'll just disappear. Who knows, it might be fun to just travel the world. Then, when that time comes... I mean nothing, I guess. Clearly she wants to come with. Hey, Oshito. You're one of the Onbiden Kaien, right? How did the Onbiden Kaien live? What kind of country is where there? What about the people? What's the culture different from ours? Oh, sweet Jesus, you have no idea. I doubt I can tell you everything in one setting. That's fine, we have plenty of time. Appreciate it. You can tell me about it, huh? Where do I begin? If my mind wanders, I let my head fall back and I gaze upward. Stars beyond number, dot the night sky. The world is just so beautiful. Seeing this now makes me feel like maybe it was work back then wasn't in vain after all. It wasn't beautiful in your time? Never saw it personally back then. Everyone lived underground. Why? Long story. Huh? I mean, we lived our lives as normally as we could down below. I had a brother that couldn't stop butting into my business, and Hun, his wife and their daughter, they all live pretty close by. They come and visit me every now and again. Family, huh? As I talk, sharing a part of my past that I've never been able to share with anyone, I feel a slight, really lightness in my chest. Oh no. Those are bad sounds. I did the thing. Unauthorized access to the central server. The carrier level elevated. Outside connection cut. Information on the server had likely been compromised. My lord. Yes, I had my suspicions. We've arrived. Your good O2 score. Straight to the capital, too. It hasn't been that long since the war between Yamato and Tusk Corps, so port security is pretty heavy. Go on, somehow managed to get us through. Somehow, huh? We then switch our carriage and take the road through a mountain range. We travel further. Density of traffic on the road makes it clear we're close to the center of the country. Get to move this. Damn. I see it. Once we cross the checkpoint, we should be close to the capital of Tusk Corps. Oh, even the music is sounding familiar. So that's it. Look up at the garrison that signifies this country's borders. Finally made this far. Feels strange sense of accomplishment, knowing Tusk Corps' capital is just on the other side. But wait, are you sure it is, alright? Seems unimaginable that they will allow the High Commander of Yamato to enter so easily. We were the political enemy not that long ago. It'll be fine. We sent a message ahead of us. I'll let them know that you're coming in secret as an ambassador. So Tusk Corps and Yamato can start trying to rebuild the relationship. When did she? You look like you're in a good mood, Fumaria. I am. I can't wait to see our sisters again. It's been so long. She comes absolutely full of joy, like a child coming home after a long trip. Are you not excited to come back, Uchinku? I'm happy, but... Alright, you snuck out without telling anyone. You're due for quite the scolding when they track us down. Fumi's happy to going home again, huh? Gohan's expression free, boop. Now that I think about it, Kuro did explain to everyone what happened, right? I recall him saying that you drugged him? Something along those lines? There was also something about being locked in a carriage with noxious fumes? I didn't want to think you could do such horrible things, Ku. Bruh. To be fair, those noxious fumes were his, and Kuon was not the one who locked him in there. It was our man Sephiroth. What did my mother say when they heard this? Oh, that's absolutely serious, of course. Shit. Come on, you seem a little pale in the face. Is something the matter? It's nothing. He looks... clearly looks disturbed. Perspiring heavily. Here's a roll of paper. We'll wait here. Take your time. That's not it. Banui made her take the fall. I can't believe it. Well, we're all hoping to get to the checkpoint and head to the capital soon as we can, but there's a lot of people lined up in front. Looks like it'll take a while for the visitors to have their capital... for the visitor to the capital to have the luggage inspected. Excuse me, you are Lord Oshitor, correct? I suddenly hear a voice from somewhere nearby, and I see a figure descend from the air above me. An oncoming area. You're gonna pay a price? Exactly. You are. Welcome to the score. It's calm you again. And man, she looks spiffy. As the representative of this country, I hereby welcome you to our shores. The disappointing beauty. The ambassador from Tuscor. She seemed very different from the last time we met. Well, sister, I'm returning to... Oh, hey, Fu. Welcome back. You ran off without telling anyone. We got so worried. My deepest apologies, sister, but it's my duty to take care of Ku. Oh, but... I told you that I was going for a little walk, didn't I? God damn, Fumaru. You're a different country? That's not a little walk. Really? I thought you used to say something like that when you used to slip out of your lesson. Look, at least I never crossed the ocean on my walks. Kami puffed her cheeks, frustrated by Fumaru's nonchalant rebuttals. He's dressed formal enough, but I guess her personality hasn't changed much. My name is Kamiya, Lord Oshitor. I shall serve as your guide. I visited Yamato as a diplomatic ambassador, and I received a most gracious welcome. I would now like to return the favor, ensure your stay here is an enjoyable one. I'm truly grateful for your kindness. And it looks like you prevented me from entering the conflict before, as a relief at least. On that note, Kamiya slowly shifts her gaze. Cool, we've been attempting to slowly tiptoe away, finally freed on the spot. Oh, cool. Where exactly are you going? Oh no. Are you playing hide and seek? I can see that tail you're so proud of, you know. Ever since you were little, you've been bad at hiding. Well, begrudgingly turns around. Are you by chance angry at me? Well, curious. I'm not mad. I'm really worried. Told you shouldn't push yourself, didn't I? And now you come right back, but you snuck out all on your own. I was really worried about you, okay? Kami talks like she's admonishing a child. Kawan seems to muster a response, and she pushes her down at the floor. I'm sorry. You don't see this every day. Kawan hangs her head in shame, unable to look Kami in the eye. Right, as long as you understand, that's all you get from me. Kawan gives a sigh of relief at those words. And Aru was really upset about all this. It'd be mean of me to scold you too much before she gets to give you a talking to. But you said you weren't angry. Right, I'm not angry on you. Oh no. Oh no. There's a sudden chill in the wind. I can see that fur and Kohan's tail standing on end. There's something behind us. There's some kind of ominous presence behind us, but I don't make a sound. They don't make a sound, just like this appeared out of thin air. Slowly turn around and see a massive beast standing before me. Staring down at the limp prey in its mouth. Still bloody, apparently fresh caught. I see our big boy has learned to get plus 10 in stealth. Ow. Well met. This thing talks? No, there's someone on his back. That was Aru, I think. Mukuru. I welcome you. This is tasty. Ah, that girl. She's so pretty. With that, the cat drops a massive catch in front of me with a thud. Quite impressive. So I should be considering this thing a gift? Appreciate the sentiment, but how the hell am I supposed to carry this thing? The liver is nutritious. That skull can make strong and unlucky as well. Should I prepare it on my... Alright, what the hell? No, 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 God, no, God, no, God, no, God, no, what? Diddle-osh. Eat plenty, get strong. Aru nods, apparently satisfied, and turns her gaze on the Kohan. That's what you do, plenty of punishment. Kohan stumbles backwards, successfully shielding her posterior. She looks desperately to Kami for help, tears welling in her eyes. Don't be too rough on her. You'll never learn anything without pain. There's a lesson we all had to learn. Oh no, she's gonna get Anju memes on. Yeah. A look of despair falls upon Kohan's face. She didn't have to do it in front of everyone like that. Ooh, Kohan's voice falls into a fever whimper as she protectively clutches her rear. Maybe should I put some ointment on you? As soon as I leave to grab the ointment, I meet Kohan's eyes. They're eerily lifeless. Tears begin to well up in her eyes. I should probably look away. Yeah, never mind. See her. Like all her bones shattered by the machine. Oh god. Why? Kamon smiles, watching us thoughtfully, then sprains her posture, facing me head on. I will not guide you to our capital. Much appreciated. Ah, Cam, you probably know. Nakura wished they'd leave. Right? And it happened twice! Because apparently that was the backstory where Eruru made the contract. But this could score the capital. Ah, I look so spiffy now. The claimed capital of Discord is much smaller than Yamato's. Cheerful throngs of people crowding the street are very reminiscent of the Imperial capital. Nations of mortals rise and fall. Keep that nice hand. In a repeating cycle of prosperity and decay, that's the natural, true way for our land and its people. Ah. Is this what you wanted to see? A country that won prosperity through military might and do enduring wars? I glance back at the Aru with a bunch of dried fruit. Probably from one of the three food stars. She keeps popping peas into their mouth. That's our little guru, I guess. She never learned to talk after swallowing, I see. Or talk after eating and finishing all our food, I see. Yes, I do. That's Stacy. We got eye contact, she finally offers one for it to me. They make their large fried grapes. If they're charm, looks pretty good. Shouldn't be buying food like that. You gotta spoil your appetite. Midway through Kamiya's disappointing reprimand, Aru crowns a piece of fruit in the other girl's mouth. That is good. That's entertaining, I guess. You want to show them the specialties of Discord, huh? Guess we got no choice. Kamiya sees a breath change of heart. She tears off a few more pieces of fruit, passing it back to us. Try some. It's a Discord specialty called Mousnew. Aru, the princess, you don't give a fuck. Yes. Keep chewing. You'll get to enjoy it until it loses flavor. Toss the Mousnew by outside chewing. It's got unique texture and shades of both sweet and sour flavors. That's a vast city, like natural gum. Not exactly what I call noble conduct, but for a while we just stroll around the street chewing our Mousnew. So it's like a weird raven gum, huh? At first, Kamiya seems determined to act like a proper guy, but she's relaxing into old habits. No one bats an eye, the massive beast Aru is riding. Get the sense that they're used to seeing the two around town. First things first, I need a Kyo in this tavern to stay in. Bowen, do you have any recommendations? Oh, that's fine, even I'm a guest. We can show you the way to the palace. Yes, I think you're here as ambassador after all. A feast awaits. I didn't think about it, took that point. I'm so relaxed here, I almost forgot. It's been so long since I've been here. Hey, Ushitor. I had to go back to my home now. I won't be able to accompany you to the palace, I think. Oh, going home, are you? No, for some time, Kohan's the daughter of some noble family. Guess she can't accompany me the whole time. I see, it is where we part ways. Farewell. I shall cherish the memories of our time together. No, that's not what I meant. Why would you jump to a conclusion like that? Kohan pals shooting me a frown. It's not? I haven't been home for a while, so I'm just going to go and say hi to my family, that's all. Said it, I suppose you're right. Your first priority should be go to see your family. Your old Kohan, a debt I can probably never repay. Perhaps I should come along to introduce myself. Suppose so? In that case, you just come with us. We're going. Wow, that's kind of adorable. good old to score content, eh? Ah. Kohan cuts in desperately, interrupting everyone if they try to answer. Then she turns to me with a strange, rigid smile. Something wrong, Kohan? In any case, you don't need to worry about me. You go ahead with everyone else, I think. I could never roll, bro. She smiled, but she seemed distracted. Just, you know, that time, sort of, kind of. It'll be fine, really. Everyone's real busy right now. I think they have a lot of free time. That's bull. Two of them right here. Rune says, I suppose. There's probably a lot of little details that make it hard to explain. It'd be rude for me to intrude on her time with her family, anyway. Sorry, well, off I go. I'll see you later. I'll be in company with Kuda. See you thus. The Kuon and Fumaril disappear into the crowded city streets. Kuo's so silly. Aru already knows what's up, and Kuo is silly. Make our way to a gemstone slip and head to the palace instead of the capital. After passing through numerous gates and being guided to the inner wards of the palace, Camu and Aru leave into my duties. What duties? I'm on vacation. And the audience hall, awaiting the arrival of Tusco's Oval. Yeah, it's going to enter princess mode? Who knows? You'll see. Wait and hope. Eventually the guards draw back like a tide and silence fills the chamber. In the back of the hall, I see a figure slowly striding towards me. I thank you for traveling so far to meet with us, Yamato, guest of Yamato. The moustache! Oh no, that is a spiffy outfit. It's like a combination of an old outfit, and then he put Hakuro's colors on top of it. Shave it. Now. I'm finally greeted by a regal-looking man with sharp, piercing eyes. Who of Tusco? Oh, well, I suppose I should expect as much from a man who rules Tusco. He's got presents. I'm to keep my wits about me. My name is Oshitor. He doesn't remember. I mean, come on, the suit is so much spiffier. Mikado has graced me with the station High Commander. I thank you for your gracious audience. And come on, it was a lifetime ago, and it was one meeting. Have I seen him before? Nah, it must be my imagination. Oh, so you're an Oshitor I've heard so much about. His eyes narrow, I can feel his gaze piercing me to my core. I would like to offer my sincerest thanks for all the aid you provided us during our civil war. Bleh. I have no intention of sending aid. If you think anyone, thank my daughter. His tone is still very guarded. He seems reluctant to even speak. He said he meant to invade his country before. Suppose it wasn't easy to get on good terms with him again. Probably not the best time to ask him about the Master Key. He's just on edge. Hmm? Two figures silently enter the audience hall. They glide to Oboro's side, whispering in his ear. They seem to have urgent news. What? Coup? In an instant, Oboro's expression completely changes. He almost shouts right then and there, but two squires quickly cover up his mouth. Hmm? Most of us in my seat are to display, but the three of them barely seem to notice me. You're sure this is true? He's currently in a room. Ah, truly. Aw, he's such a nerd. After hearing his report, Oboro suddenly looks a lot more fidgety. His fingers tap excitedly at the armrest of the throne. An urgent matter has arisen. I have prepared a feast in your honor. Keep out the dip. Keep going, dip. Please enjoy our hospitality at your leisure. I think it's taking all his power and possible. Nah, Kuan Yi. For Oboro. At the hand, the several attendants begin carrying trays crowded with fine food and drink. He's trying to leave classily. On delivering that command, he promptly rushes off somewhere. Never mind. Currently, theme looks like I'm welcome here. Look around, taking in the sight of the spread before me, vibrant, fresh, and colorful. And I carefully adjust to my seat. Oops. Fumio's leading the utter ladies of the court. I wasn't expecting it, but given how close she is with Kamu, wasn't that big of a surprise. Not in Lord Oshitor. Would you like to start off with a drink? Saint Fumio intends on serving me personally. She sits across me from a small table, beginning to pour. Oh, thank you. This side is very good. How about some of this? All these dishes go well with this layer. Go very well with the liquor. Maru and Sara offer me dishes from both sides as in competition with her. Should I really be kicking back like this before even having a proper conversation with their old? Huh? Now this is a feast. The more things change, the more they stay the same, huh? All of a sudden I notice Aru and Kami right here enjoying the food with me. Guess they're back from whenever they went. Yeah, if I'm in a rush, I guess I'll just enjoy my party then. And now the goofy shit. Jeez, Dory, girl. Thought I told them to help me. Why didn't they just leave like that? I'm not really sure how this is gonna go. Remember, she can hear the sound of someone charging that hallway, and then the door finally slams open. I'm not even gonna have to translate that. You're finally home. Oboro charges Kuan at full speed, sweeping her up in a tight embrace, clinging like he's never gonna let her go again. Kuan, promise me you'll never. Oboro's words start to muddle mid-sentence, and little by little his body goes limp. Kuan carefully holds the strip of cloth in place over his nose. Damn. Why does it always have to be so chaotic the moment I get back? What? She knocked his ass out. Oboro snores loudly, deep in slump. Shit. No, not again. Seems he was right to prepare the bed, just in case. Durin grew up, patient observers of all the preceding events, check over the unconscious Oboro, then lift him up together. Watching them, Kuan heaves an even deeper sigh than before. Durin, girl, can you handle this? Damage is often. Apparently. You may count on us. Your clothes are ready in the room provided. Thank you. Well, no use overanalyzing now, I think. One last sigh, she pulls herself together. Nodding in determination, she sets her veil in place. Banquet's in full swing. By now, the alcohol is starting to kick in a little. Go on, you bitch, you made the hunkers of that. Now you're gonna hide. Just relax, buddy. I'm taking a look at the liquor of Tuscoy. You mean be modest? Please have some more. This bottle here is a specialty local brew. I have a duty to ensure it does not impact my duties for the portal. This should be enough. No, you don't have to be so uptight. Someone suddenly wrapped their arms around me from behind. What? Hey, we're drinking as equals today. Go on, live a little. Have fun. You can't go home just yet. Let's get friends now. Pretty sure she's just drunk. And it apparently doesn't help that these characters. A lot of people noticed that Hakuro and Haku look very similar from behind. She's right, this feast is the deepened bond between our two nations, and we have so much more hospitality to show our guests. No, really, you've done more than. Oh. Romeo slides over from her place, sliding up to next to me. Let's start over with a little more intimacy. Another drink? Afraid I have important duties to attend to. I dare not impose by drinking myself to a stupor. Even better. Oh no. We shall put our heart and soul into helping every part of your body recover. Damn it, these two. I'm surrounded. Can't even budge. I suppose my only option is to let them do as they please. A shudder suddenly passes through me. It's like I can feel a cold, judgmental eye on me. Well, yeah, man just filled himself a little harem situation. What's this? It's like someone around here wants to murder me. Where have I? I still look back and forth, and my eyes fall upon the woman who just entered the room, the princess of Tuscor. Doesn't seem to have any guards, maybe because they have a diplomatic gesture, but she just stands there. Can I see her face? I can feel her glaring. You seem to be enjoying yourself. Did I do something to piss her off? Anyway, I should give her a proper greeting. Oh no! Poor Haku. It's been quite some time since we last met, Princess of Tuscor. I thank you for the hospitality you have shown me. When we sent her now, enjoying the fruits of your labor, thanks to the aid Tuscor provided us in through the chaos. I've heard that you are a fierce advocate on our behalf, Noble. Words cannot express the depth of my gratitude. Call me a bitch. You kinda is. Get here on five. You need not greet me in such a way. Simply enjoy yourself as our honored guest. Very well. I find myself in an indulgent mood. Allow me to pour you a drink. I hear everyone around us murmuring, fascinated by this turn of events. Even Kamiyu and Fumaru stare in wonder, despite their inebriation. Before I give a response, the Princess of Tuscor herself begins to pour me a cup. That's the thing. Why are you so awful uptight? Enjoy your drink. You'll see. Thank you, I appreciate it. After guests, I don't really have a reason to refuse. I gulped down the drink she's offered. A drink with pride and sincere enjoyment. I approve. I have taken quite a liking to you. Allow me to speak plainly. Enjoy. I feel like you're gonna murder me. The music sounds like you're gonna murder him. I invite you into my service. Huh? I did a double take, unable to help myself. Her face is hidden behind a veil so I can't read her expression. Oh, I can tell she's observing me carefully. What does she mean by that? She can't be serious. Was I unclear? I told you to enter my service. Oh no, she's making a schmooze. I appreciate the sentiment, however. Princess Tuscor suddenly removed her veil to reveal the face hidden beneath. What? The face before me, none other than a girl I parted ways with just a little while ago. Come on. As Princess of Tuscor. I command you once more, enter my service. Okay, that's fine. Be the one to stand beside me as my right-hand man. She's making the schmooves. Oshitori, no. Haku. I mean, gotta say, she wears that dress pretty dang well. It's pretty. I like the blues. We stare at each other for a long moment. What do I say? I knew she was probably from a noble family, but... Like Haku has... Well, besides the fact that she's already sworn to Anju service as Oshitori, you know? But there's one thing I can say. I have time for Haku to make the move. So when I got hit in the face at full force back then, that was you, huh? Damn. Just when I see her face pale slightly. I think that chipped a molar too. Damn. And the veil flies back. Who's, come on, you speak up. Seriously. please enjoy today's feast to your heart's content. Too late. The two escort awkwardly turns and abruptly leaps through. Mom wants to throw them party goers around us, resume their merrymaking. What? Are they seriously gonna pretend the whole thing didn't happen? That's kind of pushing it, don't you think? I've half a minute to try calling her back, but I decide against it. Suppose I consider that the sign of a princess's friendship. Probably better that I don't think about it too much. Doesn't change the fact that she's just Kowan after all. I suppose I can wait until after the feast is over. Yes, it will do you good to enjoy the feast for now. Yes, I think I'll do just that. I give and accept the cup from her, downing it in one gulp. Honestly, I think I need a drink after that. A song of secrets, achievement unlocked. When the Dark Colon was the princess of Jusco. Think about it, she was familiar with a lot of Jusco's political figures. Yeah, I should have seen this coming. Did you know about this? Ready to eliminate if the need arose. If anything happened, we could eliminate the target in secret so that Master's heart would not be pained. Damn. So in other words, you were aware. I had the twins give a simple nod when I repeat a question. Jesus Christ. I mean, they were designed to feel the god form, so naturally they would be able to sense the... Very well. You get a feeling it'd be pointless trying to stop them to these two. Can I come in? Kuon. The door slides open. Kuon stands in the entryway. She looks awkwardly around the room, her expression grave. Is something the matter? Why so uncertain? Ah, back to her usual outfit. Well, no particular reason. Finally, she steps hesitantly inside. Leaves herself on the cushions applied by the twins, who from who knows where. So, was something wrong? Well, I just want to know how you're doing, Ushitor. I mean, a lot's happened. How am I doing? Well, that is... You kind of outed me as Haku to everybody in the delegation at Twoscore. Including Clamu and Araru, right, because the first time I introduced him, you called her out for slugging you. To be fair, she did send him to a wall, boss. Judging from how fidgety Kuan looks, I can tell she clearly got something on her mind. You simply caught me off guard, doll. I can't help but remember when you beat the living shit out of me and smashed me to a wall. That was probably made of rocks. That probably hurt like a bitch. And knocked me so senseless I ended up slipping. I knocked out a tooth and ended up losing my mind and saying stupid shit. I thought? Did you realize how much courage it took for me to do that? Your past does not matter in my eyes. To me, you will always be Kuon, and that will never change. Thanks. And besides, I've been hiding my identity as well. There's no reason you should feel so guilty of. Yes, that's quite right, I think. Kuon. Kuon's grown expensive and vanishes like she's realized something. She draws them closer, like she's ready to pounce. I mean, you just went off and died on your own without even telling your guardian. I just didn't want to bring it up myself. Do you have any idea how much that hurt me? How sad I was. I believe I explained it before. The less who knew my secret, the better. But I am sorry. That doesn't matter. After everything you pulled, I have the right to complain, I think. No? Not really. But besides, you could have at least told me about it. I'm your guardian and everything, after all. It probably would look mad sus if you suddenly warmed up to Oshoi like he was Haku. Like, frame one. Honestly, ever since we met, you get the feeling that it might take a while. Internally, I heave a deep sigh. Twin sit silently off to the side, probably trying not to provoke her any further. I'm pretty sure they're hiding their presence from her. I know, you're kind of on coincide here? Really? I had to change the topic somehow. It will be silly if, like, she was that desperate literally after finding out Haku was dead. That's just too weird. However, having time to recollect yourself, getting along with everybody, I guess maybe, but even then it was kind of weird to an outside person how quickly she grew to Oshitor. That is like one. I believe you came here with the intention to speak on a different matter. Maybe something pressing. Yes, it's all being weird. It was good. Giving us so much good moments. She gives me a look, but the anger fades from her expression as she strains her posture again. That's not fair. You always change the subject on me like that. Anyway, I thought I was just about to head out on some errands. Wondering if you'd like to come with me. Errands? Nothing important, but I thought you might appreciate an opportunity to look around to the school. That's why you came, isn't it? Impress on you. Why is that weak? No, Haku. I actually wanted to show you around my homeland. I think that'll be the quickest way for you to learn about this country. Being in the world without a word, I suppose. Perhaps you're right. I'll be visiting your homeland after all. I ask you to be my guide, go on. We shall follow you even to the depth of the enemy territory, master. They're not letting her knock him out and do it. Let's get going then. We're all waiting for us outside. Oi. They're not risking it. If she can knock out Obero. Ooh, wow, we got spiffy. We're waiting for your arrival. We took a bit longer than we expected. Well, that's... My apologies. There were some matters I had to discuss with Koan. Are you sure that this is alright? Is Koan not the Imperial Royal President's Kuskor to work in the city without a guard? Well, I warned her about it, but... Oh, it's fine, as long as I'm going incognito. My face is usually hidden for public ceremonies. People tend not to recognize as I act natural. Is that how it is? Looked to it from real, but she remained silent, only offering me a troubled smile. Just like Munichika. Yes, there's plenty of people that have it hard. Come on, don't overthink things. Let's get going. We follow Koan through the main streets of Tuskor. Seems rather lively. When the market opens up, there'll be even more people. It's a little less crowded than usual today. Tuskor's capital doesn't seem as orderly as Yanto's. The walls and roofs of the buildings nearby give them their unique designs, giving this place a different kind of charm. Oh, sure. How does the capital of Tuskor look to you? What's your perspective? Let me see. The citizens all seem so relaxed, like they're all enjoying themselves here. Glad to hear that from you. Koan's tail sways happily as she makes a quick turn. Oh, that haberdashery over there is one of my mother's favorites. I have a smile seeing Koan so excited. Koan seems like she's enjoying herself. This is Koan I remember, but... Look around us for a moment. Is it just me, or are the people around here watching us? Do you not think that the people have realized who you are? You think? Koan stares at my face for a moment. Is it? I think it's probably you that stands out, Oshitor. I mean, with that Akaruka. You think so? Is it me that's drawing all attention? They forgot about it since it's been stuck on my face for so long. Well, to be fair, he would kind of resemble Hakuro. So the question kind of stare. Not like I could just jam another mask on over to Akaruka. As I try in vain to think of a solution, the shop's owner seemed to notice us calling out. Lady Koo! I mean, Miss Koo. Oh. Oh, hello. It's been a while. That person almost called Koan by her name, didn't they? Still, it doesn't seem like Koan's really noticed given her response. We've got some lovely new hairpins soon, since you've been gone. Wow, would you like one? They make a great gift for your mother one day. Wow. Ah. I don't know. They all have such different tastes. What do you think? Each one has a different type of flower ornament attached. Oh, those look perfect. Yeah, it sounds like the shop owner is in the know. Going around the conversation, it's pretty obvious the merchant is aware of Koan, to be honest with you. Lady Fumaru. If I'm not mistaken, the people clearly know who Koan is, do they not? Whisper quietly from Fumaru, the Ilbailan, and the one to call Haku, Fakuran again. Shh! You can't let her hear that. Is that how it is? Yes, I'm afraid if she finds out that everyone knows who she is, she'll stop coming into town. That's why everybody does their best to pretend they do not even notice. Damn. So, but Koan's usually so damn sharp. I guess she may be deluding herself. And everybody else is like, okay, we're just gonna go along with it. Ali rise. Smile crosses Fumaru's face. It's just bad. It's kind of bad. And it's like, no one of these you can see, like, oh, there are some shades of Munachika and Fumaru. Huh. Sorry to keep you waiting. After work, it wasn't that long a wait. Koan puts in their orders at the haberdashery, and then we set off our destination again. However, Miss Ku, we've got some copies of that kaidu sound of medicines you ought to order. Hey, Miss Ku, no candy day? Come on, buy some. I'll throw in an Electra. Miss Ku, I was hoping you'd come. I recall you saying you needed new textiles last time. Well, in that case, every time someone calls, Koan stops to browse and gets extra of our purchase, sometimes even more than the original purchase itself. That's the Koan's well-loved by her people. Allow me to help carry some. Oh, what you think? We shall carry it. You may leave it to us, Master. Twins grabbed the load away, apparently refusing to let me carry a thing. However, by the time we reach the end of the street, both Fumaru and I have our arms full. That is quite a lot of shopping. You will need all of it. You'll find out soon enough. Koan gives him a cheery smile. Koan may be a princess, but I didn't see her the type to go blowing this much cash on impulse shopping. This way, Oshitoa. As I think to myself, Koan suddenly pulls at my sleeve and leads me to a narrow alleyway. Where exactly we're headed? The back alleys can be dangerous. You may be attacked from the shadows. Please walk between us, Master. That's a little rude. We do have capital guards, and the crime rate here is fairly low. Koan looks back to me with a half smile. It's fine. In fact, this place has to stay safe for a certain reason. Look over there. That is... No, it's Miss Ku. Ah. Miss Ku, come play. Come on. The children seem to know, so then crowd around. I have things to do today, so maybe later. Oh, that's boring. Hey, that guy's got a weird mask. That's so weird. He may not look like it, but he's actually a very important person. No shenanigans, okay? He did not bother me. There's going to be quite a lot of children here, though. It's this place. Temple school. This is where we teach children literacy and arithmetic. Hearing those waves that turn around, seems like Eru and Kamu have joined us. You're late, Ku. We're waiting forever. But I guess there's no helping it. As long as Ku's happy, that's all that matters. Two of them look expectantly between Ku and me. I have no idea what you mean. I'm telling you that's not how it is. This exercise. It is wholesome. It's very reminiscent of the first game. I think that's what they're playing at. That is. Go on, side and aspiration. And more importantly, did you bring out an answer? All good. Of course. What are they talking about? Well, noticing my puzzle expression, Koan points to something over in the yard. It's exactly like that. Exactly. That. Follow her gaze to a large cart loaded with all sorts of vegetables, barrels, and jars. All ready. Big pot's already boiling. Let's begin, man. That. Koan straps for a rolling up sleeve and starts cutting a vegetable she takes in the cart. Ku comes here to cook for the children and comes to the temple school. I see, so that's why there's so much. I'm sure there's a little much even for all these children. Can't imagine everyone shares Koan's incredible appetite. What was that? Oh, nothing. Absolutely nothing. But that appears to be quite an entertaining. You two mind helping her? If you intend to eat as well, Master. Promise us you will have some, Master. As long as you do not add anything strange to the recipe, then yes. Oh. Looking slightly disappointed, twins reluctantly join Koan. Oi! We're feeding children! In that case, I'll go prepare the broth. Koan's chopping staff at Fumaru's words. With the knife frozen midair, a strangely heavy atmosphere descends. Fumaru, could you look after the children instead? You'll probably love to hear all your stories. No, I'm sure of it. I mean the cough, the children. Oh, damn. But Please, the children adore you. Very well, I'll go tell stories to the children then. Fumiro moves to join the children, smiling warmly as they greet her. As I watch the exchange, I feel a hand descend on my shoulder. Can you go play with the children too, Lord Ostor? They're really energetic, so you have to have a lot of energy to keep up. Prepare yourself. Such a task will be a trifle. Yep. Colin's trying to make the shoes. Hey, Mr. Mass, lift me up. Me too. I want a Whopper ride. Wait, ah! Hey, mister. Over here. I have you now. Children tauntingly waving his hand, I wave my crude water gun, pulling trigger as high as I can. The children swiftly dodge as the stream slides against the ground. Curses! I missed! I prepare for a second shot, but I realize I'm out of water. Time for a tactical retreat. I made a mad dash for the bucket we filled. I see the rest of the children have been waiting for the perfect ambush. This cannot be! I try to stop and turn, but my fate is sealed. Ha! Turn's aim is true. The water pelts me straight in the face. You lose, mister. I'm pretty bad at this, mister. They may have strength in numbers, but this is still a battle of children versus an adult. What comfort do I need? A gasp and my quick defeat. How? I survived so many battles, yet I cannot win a child's water gun fight. Damn, man's confidence got shook. Good work. Go on. I think you really hit off the kids. Colin reaches out to me, I take her hand, pulling myself back to my feet. A hot pot pot's on, so what are we eating here? I'm sure the children are hungry too. Yeah, let's... Fragrant smell fills the air. Very well, eating contest then. I should not be defeated in this one, unless of course I'm up against Colin. What's that supposed to mean? I was afraid of children. I had to show good table manners. Koan lightly cuffs the back of my head in a quick smack. Jeez. Children flock around excitedly, hearing our banter. Mr. Math, are you Miss Ku's husband? Oh, damn. Hey, you kids can't go making fun of Koan like that. Koan looks like two children? Honestly. Children, no. The children are trying to wingman. It's kinda impressive how quickly they were. Well then. Thank you for the food. Jojo began to scarf down the food. Here, Ostor, this one's for you. This dish is called Moro Hot Pot. Come in to explore the home cooked meal. Thank you. Take the bowl from where and lift it to my lips. This is. What do you think? It's good. I don't know how to put it. It was oddly comforting just to hear like this. Good. I'm glad to hear you say that. Colin gives a sigh of relief at my appraisal. I hear you're often making food for children when you're here. Mm-hmm. Been a while though. Colin seems oddly wistful watching the children with gentle old look in their eyes. This used to be an orphanage that Mother Ulti used and started. Now though, kids come here to learn even if they have parents at home. Oh. Aw. Orphanage. We had a huge war a while back, and the aftermath was difficult for people. There was a time where we could come here to study as well. That's right. I've been with Ku ever since then. That's why I consider all the children here as my little brothers and sisters. And that's why you. Things have gotten much better than they were, but we can never say for sure what the future holds. That's why these children need to eat, play, and study while they still can. After all, the future Driscoll rests on their shoulders. Yeah, you're right. But there's only the real princess after all. Doing a lot more work than Andrew is at this moment. Damn. Making it look kind of bad. Just focus on my search for the masterpiece here. That's all I can do about any information to work from. Mind if I come in for a bit? Aren't you sick, baby? Jeez. Not at all, please come in. There's something you need from me. It's not a particularly pressing matter. Take a seat, see me choosing your words carefully. Ostor, you're looking for this message, right? Yes. Call the words that I was told. It was some decades ago now, I believe. I found a signal of Vindicatrix Driscoll. Signal that belonged to the Master Key. A key, indeed, to everything. That key, one may restore life to these ancient facilities. The ruins would hum with power and purpose once more. I can only require this key, I thought. Perhaps I can unlock some way to save my brother. Can't wait to piss off all this stuff for a key, man. I finally died. I mean, we know where the key is, and I know they don't really need it, and they haven't used it in decades. And that's all the information I have to work from. Maybe it's just core, without any other clues. But this might become difficult. I don't think they really particularly even mind about that. I may have an idea where it might be. What? I mean, closer, keen to hear the rest. Koan, give me a small nod. Where's this place then? Koan looks warily around the room for a moment and speaks somewhat louder. She's talking to someone outside the room. It's a very holy place. There's only one person aside from me that's allowed in there. Right? Only one person besides me can ever enter that place. Why should repeat herself? I was thinking about showing you the way. Wait, this place is close by? I suppose you could say that. And she thinks the Master Key might be there? Koan says it's safe bet that floor it is. I must ask you to act my guide. Alright, follow me then. Koan, can I ask you a question? You're really quite sure it is the place? Pretty sure anyway. Feels as though I've been walking for a while now. Passed through a doorway in the castle that seems to lead entrance to a shrine. It takes the steps underground to a long pathway. To be honest, I can't say that there's a straight path. With all this darkness, I can't even tell anything for sure. These walls and floors are all made of stone. I say these were built after the fact rather than being part of the ruins. Pathways seem to ride to be a suitable walkway. Perhaps they've simply transferred cargo to it? Or maybe they had some other use in mind. And my fingers trace along the wall, and made our way further in the darkness, still deep in thought. Here, Koan, make a step in front of me like she almost tripped on something. Are you alright? Right, yes, I am fine. Just because you bother me in this pitch black, we may end up hurting ourselves. The thought occurs to me. If the king pits off Hakuro? Oh no. Boss fight! You ready to fight Hakuro with only like 4 party members? Shit! It comes to become a small voice. I hope we held hands, I think. Yes, you do have a point. Could be dangerous otherwise, when it's so dark in here. Right. Pause as Koan reaches out and I feel her grasp my hand tightly. Good, let us proceed with caution. Damn, she's making a schmooze. They fight him. They won't win, but... ooh. I know that they went on this far. Hold on, Koan. Did you offer me to guide me to a place you've never actually been to? No, that's not exactly true, I guess. Been here several times as a child. Back then, I was curious where this path led to. But you were a child. You were coming alone? Guess that sounds like Koan, now that I think about it. Everyone calls it the reliquary. But they never really told me what was in here. Reliquary? The word used for ancient places where artifacts are stored. Does it make you excited just to hear the name? Well, if you have a point... Absorbing the conversation, I didn't notice there was a wall in front of us until I walked right into it. Are you alright? Yeah, I'm fine. I wasn't expecting there to be a wall here all of a sudden. Reach out casually to check the wall that blocked our way. But there's still a dead end here. Still, you knew it wasn't gonna be a dead end? I've come here many times, but I never could find a way past this point. I feel calm pressing the wall alongside me to check for yourself and no frustration in her voice. I was hoping this time, maybe things would be different. I won't be any different this time. As I ask, I reach again to tap experimentally at the wall before us. The surface is smooth. The material is apparently different from that of the other walls. And that moment, something moves in the darkness and we feel a small gust of wind. We reach out once more. The wall before us has vanished as it melts into the darkness itself. Oh. Have I tweaked the tongue? Nope, never mind. All it needed to do is human fingerprint detected. Wall opening. A hidden door? One opened for Koan, but when I got close, something didn't activate. This must mean Masakana's facility. Is it still possibly functional? Try to peer ahead, but darkness seems to go on forever. Let's go, are you ready? Wait, we have to be careful. Let's take it slowly. Despite her words, you can tell her tail is twitching in excitement. Perhaps you should calm down first. Well, I'll take the lead. Might be dangerous. So stay behind me. Very well. Be sure not to let your guard down. Take my place behind the enthusiastic Koan and we move forward together, sticking close to the walls. Looks like it's some kind of room. A pretty spacious. Don't know if anything's actually in there. Maybe there used to be things stored in here, or maybe this place was abandoned for some reason. Huh? Is there another wall in the way? She's right. We'll come to another dead end. It's not very weird, anyway. Then this place is completely empty. No. Koan heaves a deep sigh. Disappointment is pretty apparent. But we made it all this way, too. She must have really been curious to know what was in here. Guess I understand the sentiment. This place might be the reason why she got so interested in art and show artifacts in the first place. I'm sorry. What do you have to apologize for? I made you come all this way and there's nothing here. That's hardly your fault, Kuon. I was well aware that the Master Key would not be found so easily. But I intend to continue my search. You will help me, won't you? Of course. Kuon's bright voice echoes through the room. Silence falls once more, but I hear some sound from Kuon, and she just realized something. Oh, what is it? I guess it's been a while since we had a moment together like this. Really, feels like there's been several times where it's just been the two of us, like when you visited my room just earlier. That's not exactly a calm moment together. It's completely different. Oh, right. But it feels a little strange, too. I'm really nostalgic. Talking to each other in the dark like this, it kind of reminds me of when we first met. As well as does. Stand it feeling very well. In the dark, alone together with the girl who's been with me since the beginning. Since the moment I awakened in this world, Kuon. Neither of us break the silence, but I feel something from Kuon, like she's coming to a decision or something. There's something I want to say. Would you hear me out? What's this all of a sudden? Well. I understand your position and I know why I'm not supposed to call you by that name. But you have been ignoring that rule. But when it's just the two of us, just us together, is it alright if I call you Haku? Guess not, huh? Aww, okay. You may do as you please. Right. I'll do just that. Kuon looked up happily. Haku. Haku. Oh, Jesus. Poor girl. Yes? Haku. Kuon moved a little closer to me, fumbling along the wall. For a moment, all I wanted to do was reach over and pull her closer, but as I turned to her, the wall around my shoulder suddenly crumbled apart. What the? Pressed my hand against the edge of the small gap. The rest of the wall around it begins to crumble in pieces. Is there more to this room behind all this? As if to confirm my suspicions, the hole opens up wide enough for a person to pass through, leading to further darkness beyond. Both look at each other. Shall we? At that, Kuon leaps through the hole in the wall, as if I have any choice. Chuckling wildly, I follow behind. Through the hole, we find another pathway. The walls do not seem very sturdy here. We should be careful as we proceed, Kuon. Yes, I know. She's been wanting to stay there for so long. She has. She knows, huh? Judging by her twitching tail, I'm guessing she's running on pure curiosity right now. Oh, light! Nice to be Haku take a ruler. That'd be a cute moment. Eventually come out to an open area. In the middle of the room, we see some kind of stone monument topped with some kind of metal plating. Well, I can say it looks like the metals are engraved in the metal. Would this be Eldscript? Kuon hesitantly touches the monument as the letters begin to glow with a faint blue light. It glows! Her demeanor completely changed before she studied the monument intently. Maybe it still looks functional. What could have who could have imagined? Kinda ruined the mood, really. Damn. As I watch Kuon trace, swipe, and tap the glowing letters, an idea popped in my head. Hold on, if that's some kind of authentication device, let me take a look. You can read this. Kuon's eyes gleam with curiosity as I peeked over my shoulder. The letters blink on and off into my gaze. I see. What is it? What does it say? Well, it's a little too dark to make out. Just hold on a moment. Just let me get a closer look. Touch the letters as I speak. Oh no. Huh? I feel a giant wall sliding over before me. These are! Oh. Oh. Dying light illuminates the room and we see before us. The Abkamus. It's the Gundam. What are these things? They're like massive suits of armor, but sitting down, this is the only way I can describe them. Oh no, their dense chains wrapped around their torsos and limbs like they had to be restrained. These are Abkamus. Abkamus. So there were Abkamus underneath the score the whole time? invincible soldiers known as the armaments of the gods. These things can move. And a while back, a country waged war with them, causing incredible destruction. It's the first time I've seen one in person. Are these spares? Or have they just always been down here? Go downstairs and Master Sentinel, utterly fascinated. This thing? What, you don't believe me? No, that's not what I'm saying. Kamu. Why does it feel so... Wait a sec, are these things Abel Kamus? Abel? I'm sure that's Kamus, I think. They've got some weird medieval armor on, but Abel Heavy Industries. Humanoid protective equipment for extreme conditions. Kamu, Type 3, or Abel Kamus. These biotech mech suits were part of a major tool for the Gaia remediation project. Why is something like this doing? Wait, you said they used these things for war? I know I've been using the Akuruka and all, but using these things is kind of cheating, don't you think? Haku, you actually know what these things are? Oh no. Do I know what they are? These things were essential for our lives back then. Then can you use it? No, that I can't do. Any special credentials to use one of these? Oh, that's a little disappointing. Well, if I had a license, they'd probably force me into some manual labor job. Well, even if it doesn't have a pilot, we can give it simpler commands through the control panel. In any case, it doesn't seem like there's any clue to the master key's whereabouts here. Control? You mean this glowing tablet? Well, judging how much effort I took in hiding these away, probably dangerous to stick around for any longer. Go on, we should probably head back now. Oh no. Oh no. What? Haku, this is amazing, it actually moves. Wait, move. The music. The music. Oh no. PTSD. No, 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 no. Oh, wait, move. What do you... Get the squad. We fight. Make a giant suit of armor. Slowly rises to a feet. Chains. Each link is thick as an adult's arm, snap one by one as if made by twigs. Oh shit. Wow, it actually moves. Kuon whispers in sheer joy. In her hand, I see a tablet that was supposed to stay atop the stand. What the hell is she doing? Look, Haku, this thing still works. I've come with arm move as if reacting to Kuon's words. Defense mechanism. Oh no. Slams the arms into the wall of the room. Dust and shards of stone rain on us. Walls slowly crumble as the suit crashes like a child knocking down a pop tile and blocking building blocks. Hey! So there's one of the arms, so maybe this one works the legs? Hold it, Kuon. If you do that here, it'll... And then if I do this... Every single time Kuon touches something on the panel, the opportunity swings his body in a new direction. Kuon, stop! Try to get her attention, but she's too absorbed in the panel's work and still listening to me. Akuma kicks up particularly high, losing his balance and falls into the wall and it would crash. The resulting cloud of dust fills the air, completely blocking our roof. This isn't good. This place can come down at any moment. We need to get out of here now. Akuma's hand drags her towards the exit. Run as fast as we can down the dark passageway. We can hear something crashing behind us, slamming into the walls as it pursues. I don't even need to know what to look for. Why is the thing chasing us? Oh, so big, but still so fast, even in cramped conditions. There's not the time to be impressed. Give her a look. Kuon's curiosity still wins out, even when our lives are on the line. But in her hands, I see, she's still got the tablet that's been holding in place on that stand. Why are you still carrying that thing? Hurry up and toss it. Why? What do you mean, why? Actually, we should probably hurry. The whole place might collapse. Holding ahead, we managed to keep our distance from the thing. Finally, we see a sliver of light in the darkness ahead. It's the exit. It's all good as a giant slam against the stone walls as the path to the top of it. Then... Oh, this is gonna be a really hard fight, huh? Shoot. Yep. Finally made it out of the dark hallway. Immediately, the upcoming stops and kneels down. Oh, maybe not? It stopped. I wonder what happened to it. It was automatically following us because you were carrying that thing. That's why I told you to toss it. This? Hey, be careful with that. Who knows what you might do? Boss fight it is the... Quickly snatched the tablet from her hands. Wait, let me take it with it just a little longer. Stop! Kona tries to pull the tablet from my grasp. Just a little bit longer. Promise it'll just be a little bit. Kona's finger slides across the shape of the panel. And suddenly... Please confirm your choice. It speaks? Without warning, a black and yellow striped border appears on the tablet screen. It's definitely some kind of emergency mode. What is this? Hey, you're supposed to press this one here. Can I press it? Can I? No. Don't. Do not press. Wait. What did you just do? Do not press it. Bad things will happen. Whatever you do. Don't press that button. Silly music. No. Huh? You mean it's actually gonna make something big happen? Really? Don't do it, alright? Please don't do it. Shaking my head. Are you? Yep. Order confirmed. Now entering emergency defense mode. The upcoming dashed around like an angry god, threatening anyone who dares to approach it. The ground shakes with every stomp, and it flails its arms straight into nearby trees, knocking them over with ease. Clearly, we'll never be able to get close to it like this. It just fails? Yes. Come on. Sorry. Kinda couldn't help myself. It's emergency defense mode. It just starts smacking whatever is close by. No use crying with spilled milk. We need to stop this thing somehow. As you say, but what do we actually do? Oh, make sure not to break it. I'm the one that gets punished if that happens. That's not the problem here. I mean, how are we supposed to stop that? I'll try to shut down command first. Haku? I have no idea how to command this thing. Guess all we do is wait till it runs out of power. But these things go for days without refueling. What do I do? Its face can attack anything it registers as a threat. I look desperately around the area, hoping I might find something that'll give me an idea. And then... Okay, are you all done? Who are you? We have come to help. Master, you may leave the rest to us. Oh no, you came for us? Well, well past the time you said you'd be done, and things seem a little hectic. Am I a potter? No, not really. You came just in time. Indeed, you have. I'm sorry. But I must ask for your aid. Earthy command. You seem disappointed. Very frustrating to have a nice moment interrupted, isn't it? This is Koan's own fault. But they're gonna gloat. Now that the help's arrived, it looks like things may work out after all. Make sure to keep your distance and slowly bait it out. Sturdy. But we should be able to stop its movements. Didn't think their powers would work even on an Abel Kamu. It's a help, but kind of scary when I think about it. Looks like it slowed down a little. I feel a little sorry for the poor thing. Bizarre. Unable to read the dots of this one. But it's still clear it has ill intent. You gotta let your guard down, and must stay vigilant until it comes to a complete stop. My eyes flick at the Koan, who seems to be fiddling with the tablet. Koan? What the hell? Oi. I started acting like this because I pressed this here. Maybe if I press here. Target confirmed the magic threat. Now entering full annihilation mode. Why did he not take this? Huh? Oh, it's just beginning to calm down. Whatever could have happened? Stronger. There's no mosity from it, but its will to fight is stronger than ever. Homie, can I catch Drake? This is why you do not let kids touch your electronics, everybody. We had to get the hell out of here now. Wait, no. Just take this rampage all the way to the palace. My lady, what have you gotten into now? This is clearly one of the Abkamu we had sealed away. Minami, Kuro! Don't tell me, my lady, did you open up the relinquary? Well, about that. Big trouble now. Save discussion. Our foremost priority is to stop it. We all work together trying to stop that raging Abkamu, but even with reinforcements, the situation still seems dire. Excuse? Damn it, they're getting us nowhere. What do we do now, Chief? You're trying not to break it? We could try to capture it gently if you can. I'm afraid that may not be an option. The energy supply is practically infinite, so I suppose that should be expected. Look at the tablet over Hikoan's shoulder, but I have no idea how to work the thing. It's impossible for a civilian like me to figure out how it works. Remember Hakuoku really tight. Hakuoku really tight. Exactly. Now find some way to enter command for it to stop. I mean, Benui and crew will technically learn the weak spots so they can't destroy it, but they don't want to. And I definitely try to take control of the machine. A lightly looking button appears in the corner of the screen. This is it. Order accepted. Progressing to full area annihilation mode. Are you kidding me? How many attack modes do you have? You're a glorified hazmat suit! Bruh, do you bruh, this is a hazmat suit with like 5 attack modes, what the fuck? Amazing, it's getting even stronger! Mikoto, I advise survival over Scarleaf curiosity in this case. It's almost like someone's giving orders to this hunk of junk. Please, let them be able to handle it. And please don't let them realize whose fault this is. Crawling around to defeat a thing. Obviously, work over time. I'm trying every possible force point I can think of until I notice a button that looks like the one. Please, let this work. Emergency shutdown command accepted. Yes! Password identification required for emergency shutout of the offensive routine. Please use the voice command to input the password. What the hell are you talking about? Oh no, we need a password! Fuck. Terminal falls silent, been waiting for the voice input, which while the AppCom continues to rampage about. Open sesame? Incorrect password. Ceasefire. Shut down. Halt! Stop! Just stop! Incorrect password. Should I just break the terminal? No, that'll just make it impossible to stop that thing. What can I do? Danger. Master, it's coming for you! This is tragic. It is. Before I know it, the Abkhan's giant form looms over me. Lord Oshitor. Guess we gotta use the mask, huh? It's too dangerous, run! But the Abkhan just stands there as if waiting for something. Oh, this music's different. Keep calm. Think carefully. Don't try to figure out the password. Just try to figure out the intent behind it. These are construction units, but they don't really function properly. Or rather, they don't process commands properly. If I had to guess, the engineer in charge of maintaining these things half-assed the entire job. Which means that the master password for this unit probably isn't anything too complicated. If I were a lazy engineer and I wanted to make maintenance go as quickly as possible, then I'd make the password. I have a flash of brilliance. How the fuck? Flash brilliance time. That is so smart. Slowly raise the terminal up and Aokami moves with it as if responding. Innocent servant, hollow of form, hear my almighty words. Not like a galaxy ranger. Password! Command accepted. I'm done. None. Nope. We were here, and the day was saved, because the engineer was a lady. Abkhamu kneels down immediately, falling absolutely still. You telling me, Pop, that that wouldn't happen? That there aren't lazy people who leave their password as password? You and I both know. You're kidding. That actually worked. What happened there? He stopped that thing with a single word. Seems like even these relics yield to the authority of one of Yamato's finest Mononofu. By the way, are you trying to be smart or do you actually mean it? I can't tell any more of you. What was that word you just used? Can you teach it to me? Please, please, please. No. That is something I cannot do. Why not? Anyway, being a smart ass, I was like, are you being a smart ass right now, or do you actually mean it? I can't tell anymore, my man. Reveal the truth. Could betray my contract with those who once ruled this world and tarnish their honor. I mean, I guess I can kind of sympathize, I suppose. Cause Bob, contract, honor. I cannot speak in great detail, you know, but I have the general idea. Wasn't that important? I mean, one of them. Get that bit. I feel like if this were more modern, the password would be something like Twitter. Cool, I'm still curious. Yeah, go on, it's password. But I managed to convince her not to pry any further. I just tried around the now silent outcome. I'm curious at how it suddenly stopped moving. However, this chance encounter will prove to be dramatic accelerate events in the days to come. One morning, a number of days after I first arrived in Tuscor, I wake with my head ringing in pain. Perhaps I drank a little too much. Master here. God, wonderful. We have prepared water for you. Gratefully, I accept the cup and gulp it down. Most refreshing. Can you remember the last time I let myself drink enough to have a hangover? Smiling? Master, have you done something pleasing? Didn't realize I was smiling until the twins had pointed it out. Perhaps I'm feeling a little more comfortable in this foreign land. That thought on my mind, the twins helped me wash my face and change my clothes. Good morning, Hakushitora. Are you awake? Yes. Koan and Fumrio enter my room. Koan carried the change of clothes for me, and Fumrio carried the jug of water. Oh. Small sound of surprise escapes her as you notice I already prepared myself for the day.
Wow.
Twins look oddly smug if they watch Koan. This is my homeland, and I'm the host. You two can afford to relax a bit, you know. Damn. Damn indeed. It is our duty. It is our joy to be of service to our master. Such hard workers. Sounds pleasant enough, but I'm feeling a chill for some reason. Look at our Fumrio and say that she's nodding off to sleep as she stands there. Body teeters on her side and she nearly topples over. Whoa! We move to catch her. Not only did I end up holding her in an embrace, my hand somehow firmly planted on Fumrio's bosom. My apologies. You need mind and thank you. The usual Fumrio seems completely unbothered, smiling back at me. Spilled the water all over herself when she tripped, and parts of her clothes are looking worryingly transparent. This isn't good. Oh no. Try to put some distance between us, but with Fumrio leaning on me like this, that doesn't really work. Impressive! To accomplish such a feat so naturally. She truly is a master of the craft. What's that I wonder? Is Fumrio doing this shit on purpose? Bruh. As the twins look upon her in awe, Koan continues to smile in silence. You too. Think I know where this is going. Where I have a chance to prepare, Toran's tail snakes around my head. Erunga. Kinda brings back memories, doesn't it? Oh. Eru did that too, huh? I have no idea when Aru and Kamio arrived, but they're standing by thoughtfully watching us. Noticing the two of them, Koan hurriedly releases me from her tail. That's it. Good morning, what brings you here? I expect this time, but none of you showed up, so we came to get you. Oh, my apologies, I should head over at once. Right around the time we finished breakfast, a messenger arrived at Tuscor's palace. An urgent message. Thank you. Here you are, young master. Thanks. Robo opens the letter, silently looking over its contents. What seems to be the matter? Lady Ulturi will be visiting. Lady Ulturi? When will she be arriving? According to the message, she's already left. At the earliest, I say she may arrive within the day. Ooh, that is. Things may get busy around here. At the breakfast, I noticed the palace seems to be more hectic than usual. The court ladies, usually silent, all anxiously whispering to each other. Everyone seems rather busy all of a sudden. There is someone who is arriving here. Mother is coming to visit. Kuan arrives at my room, holding a tray with tea and snacks, seemingly right at home. Lady Oru, she's one of my mothers, as well as the Oyen Kankuru of the Omkami Yonkai, the leader of the center of the worship for Uso Nemetia. She's a very warm and kind person. She is the kindest of my mothers, yes? But she can also be the scariest, too. Ooh, I get so mad at you for that one time. You are a noble sacrifice, Ku. Wow. Does that mean that Aru and Kamu sacrificed her? Kamu and Aru nonchalantly munch on snacks, they join the chat. Let's not talk about that. Kuan suddenly clams up, darting a nervous glance in my direction. Well, doesn't sound who we found to. Yes, doesn't sound like I should pry. So essentially, a person of high status is visiting soon. Everyone's preparing. That sums it up. Everyone's working quite hard, it seems. She'd really be sitting around here with me. Well, that is. We might end up being more hindrance than help. The girl that just go, or avoid my gaze. In fact, she had a whole character progression from it. Jesus, right? The most more important subject at hand is this Oyen Kankuru of the Omkami Yonkai. It's possible they want to know something about the Master Key. Hey, Lord Ushtar, you intend on staying here for a while, right? Yes. Let's go somewhere. I can show you more stuff around this place. Hunt for beehives. Sister, I'm not sure he has the time for those kind of things. I see. Right through you. You just run off on your own together to have some fun. Not fair. Excuse me? Hey, that's not true. I've been holding myself back from asking him to go to those ruins again. Please. You still want to go back there after all we went through? These two, Kamu and Aru, was it? They always seem to be together. Not to mention they loiter around my room. Jeez, look at all the crumbs they're dropping all over the place. Good, but you're grabbing that snack over there? Not even that far from you. Stop being so lazy. I want you to give it to me, Ku. You're hopeless. Gohan grumbles to herself, but then she gets up and does her bidding. Foo, clean my ears, please. Of course, if you could just lie down here. Aru rests her head on Fumaru's lap as she's towed. Now let's begin. Wait. Kami watches Aru enjoying herself and leads forward in excitement. Ooh, me too. Would you mind it, Ku? She rolls over to Kuan, giving her the most begging look she can manage. Come on, you two. They're taking laziness to a new level, I think. Hard to tell who's supposed to be the older sister when they act like this. Children call that every time. Yes, fine. Don't think I ever heard Kamu beg for something like that in quite a while. Oh, it's time. It's over. At that voice, I turn to see an unfamiliar woman standing in the doorway. She got pretty. Whoa. She stands there with regal poise, looking. She's so pretty. She got prettier. Looking kindly at the girl flopping around on the ground. Boob. I never met her before. She must be the Omkami Yonkai. I have to say, of all the women I met in this country, you're beautiful. But she's an entirely different level. She enters the room, immediately seats herself with grace, then she taps her lap with her hand. Come then. Brat, sister, you're already here? But what about your audience with the Owl? Kamu hurriedly sits up, straining her posture in an instant, but she can't hide her confusion and excitement. This visit was somewhat spur of the moment. We agreed there'd be no need to stand on ceremony. Come now. Tap, tap. All three tap their lap once more, bringing her over. That's a little... Miss Altery! In the uncertain pause, Fumari happily leaps up, exclaiming in joy as she bounds into Altery's arms. He buries her face in Altery's bosom without a moment's hesitation. My. Still such a child, even now that you've grown up so much. Yes, Altery. Quick. It's fine. Come. Your beautiful hair will be such a mess if you keep this up. She turns Fumiru gently around, then takes out a comb from her sleeve and gently begins to brush Fumiru's hair. Oh, it feels nice. Aww. Yes, Fumiru looks like she can complete this. Altery, serene smile remains unchanged. Fumiru closes her eyes at Altery's gentle touch, looking more relaxed than she has ever been. Altery seems in high spirits as well, as she combs through Fumiru's hair. She begins to sing in a soft, lilting voice. Feels like it's so long since I've heard your last Haikyuu song, Miss Altery. If that's so, she nods with a smile as Fumiru hums along. It's like watching a mother and child who adore each other completely. I'm thinking I haven't seen Fumiru act like a child before. Oh, it's a duet! I support it so much. Koan?
Cool.
I glance at my side, noticing Koan has an oddly sad smile on her face. You'll understand one day. Why is she acting like she's the adult here? Incidentally, Kami, Muto wished you to return soon. Quite a lot of work that's piled up in your absence. Ah? Kami looks very flustered. I have some things to do here, so maybe in a little bit. Then you leave me no choice then. Ah, the boy! Ah, boy! Muto, you haven't aged a bit! God damn! Muto's still alive? Yes. Muto? I have brought all the documents that require your attention. I trust you have no qualms about performing your duties here then. Muto, you haven't aged a day, you old bastard. Good to see you. Good to see you. Kami sweats profusely. Farewell! Kami belts on an attempt to fly away, but Muto immediately moves to block her path as if he predicted her next move. I thank not everyone on my mark. That old man with some dignity and courage. Understood. An army of priests. Many figures wearing priestly robes rushed into the room and quickly surround Kamiu. Kamiuriak! Damn, the man devised a goddamn sealing spell for her. Swoosh thud. Kamiu falls to the ground like a bug that's been zapped. I can't move. This is truly the culmination of all the mystic power of the Unkami Yonkai. A spell we developed specifically to seal your powers, Princess. As impressive yet that. Could you imagine the tragedy his life has been for him to be? Damn. Don't you guys have anything better to do? And no duty greater than fixing that appalling laziness of yours, Princess. Now you will surrender to us. You are hereby grounded until your duties are complete. So lazy the Kurikei has failed to keep her in one place. Yes, you keep on flying away. But it died. No. The Yamato, the priest, reveals stacks and stacks of documents and scrolls. Haru, help me. Kamiu dragged away, she desperately grasps Aru's ankles. Mwah! Grab. Mwah! Without hesitation, Aru reaches out for Mukuro standing next to her and grabs a fistful of fur. Don't know when to give up, do you? At his command, the priest gathers with one and all of them begin to pull at Kamiu. Heave ho! Heave ho! No! Oi! Wasn't Mukuru's fur so strong that it required, like, water to weaken it, and it was practically armor? Man, there's a lot of priests, and they're trying very hard as they continue to pull clumps of Mukuru's fur closer and closer to coming out. Buddy, I loved, lovely to see that in 20 years you haven't changed a bit. And so their attempts to end in futility as Eru and Kamiyo are drawn tagged off. Aww, buddy. Leaving the giant beast whimpering on a new ball patch. Aww, buddy. You need to stay with a bit. You're ready for them to fight, huh? Ready for the murder? You have like a strongest path to. Safe was not an ill put. Eventually, Fumio's building slows to an even rhythm, leading into Altaria as she sleeps. Altaria gradually stops combing Fumio's hair, meeting my eyes. Can I bring myself to look away? It says her gaze pierces right through me, like she knows everything about me. I must apologize for the chaos that followed my intrusion. Allow me to introduce myself. I am the current Onyankuru of the Onkami Yonkai. I am called Altari. Twins need to sense something as they stand before me, readying themselves. Please stand back. You may leave her to us, Master. Oh, she is not our enemy. Why are you two so on edge? Understood. If that's your command, Master. With that, the two of them glide back behind me. My apologies. Seems my companions have gotten the wrong impression. Take no offense, you may risk it, Yuki. Thank you. Now then, I would like to say that it's an honor to meet you, Lord Oshitor. Smiles of regal dignity. I thank you for the courteous introduction. I am. As I begin to introduce myself, my words are gently interrupted. I'm well aware, a man of great distinction, a great father, all the Onbinkaien. I also know that the appearance you show me is not your own. How does she know? Did Koan tell her about me? Knew it. Yet, her only reply was a shake of her head. I know what you desire as well. Oh, three's too smart. Yes. Jeez. She big brained. Lady Ultra, you are aware of the truth behind the cursed beings? Yes. Yes. However, the truth I am not permitted to speak aloud. And why exactly are you not allowed? They were doomed to eternal suffering. I'm afraid we cannot speak no more of this matter. Not here. Nor can we speak of the key. The key, you say? Yes, the key that can open the door to the world's truth. Just suspected you know something about the master key. Lady Altaria, I beseech you, please tell me. Where am I when I find this key? What do you intend on doing once you do find it? Of course I meet Altari's pure focused gaze and find myself hesitating. The way she speaks, Master Key really is the key to everything. Doesn't seem like she'll hand it over so easily. That said, I highly doubt I'll be able to take it by force. Not that I intend on trying that. No use in trying any cheap tricks. I'll be able to keep any secrets from those eyes of hers anyway. Very well, I shall tell you everything. I have come here into Tisco in search of this key. The key is required for me to accomplish a duty that is close to my heart. I see. That smile flickered across her face as she answers. Under no circumstances, such words would seal your fate. However, if it is you, you could perhaps. As you come to my homeland, the Onkami Yonkai, the land where God walks. Or sleeps, rather. In my her eyes, I see kindness, sympathy, and sorrow. After that, I cannot bring myself to ask anything more. Once being Aku ain't so bad. We depart for the Onkami Yonkai the next morning. It occurs to me that we're being rude, forcing such an important figure to go home so soon, but I cannot stop myself. We would be dead otherwise. Exactly. We need to hurry. If you'd be kind enough to show us the way. Of course, that's why I came here. Let's go then. We shall accompany you. I'm going to. Damn. Done. Wait. You may, after you complete all your duties. Apprehended, Kamiyo plunges swiftly to the ground and tweets slowly drag her away. I'll be relying on guidance then. Yes, very well. Let's get going then. As you wish. And when we were there, we didn't see anything. F. Indeed. Something smells fishy. In a land far from Tusker's capital, deep within a vast forest of the foot of the towering mountain, lies the holy shrine Nostalgic, the resting place of the Liberator, the great deity Utsumitia. A holy land that protects their ancient knowledge of the past. War has claimed the earthly form of the deity, yet his wrathful soul remains to observe all. Knowing this, the people have named this land with due reverence, the Onkami Yonkai, the resting place of their Onkami. The land where God sleeps. If it is time, it may very well be, but it will probably have to be next stream. For now, let us step into the land. We're almost there then. Many days after leaving the capital, we ride down the road on Onkami Yonkai, taking a carriage that the locals prepare for us. I hear the Onkami Yonkai is a forbidden land. Not even the royalty of Discord can enter its death without permission. And now they're inviting the general of the land they once tried to invade them? Really thinking we're trying to save humans? Bad idea, Haku. Yeah. But he has to try. As an honored guest, no less. What does it all mean? What are your intentions here? Is something the matter? Go on, give me a questioning look. It's nothing. By the way, Kon, have you heard any details surrounding this whole visit? Not really. But I'd like to feel a little gratitude, I think. If I hadn't spoken up, you would have ended up going on your own. I thought that might make you a little anxious, so I decided to come along. Yes, you are right. I know nothing of this land. You've been a great help. I don't know, something tells me ultimately probably was sought out, Haku. Come on, you realize you're wagging your tail the same way you do when you're investigating a ring from ruin? Guess it'd be rude to say that out loud. Let me sense someone looking at me. Glance the Ultri and see that she's watching us with a smile. What is she thinking? Every time I answer a question, I get a, "You will know once we arrive," or, "I cannot speak of that here." Oh well, not like I'm not used to winging up the stuff anyways. No use to getting worked up. Right, not a good thing that I'm used to it, Guess I'm pulling my sleeve. Master, please take a look over there. Not to refuse. She does. Look the way the twins are pointing, pushing the blinds, the carriage window outside. The carriage passes a slightly elevated area. I see a green forest. It looks like a sea of trees. Alright, remember never this tree off the path and wander into the forest. There's something in there? The branch of the soap think no sunlight makes it through the forest floor. You lose your way in no time, I think. Not only that, but something interferes with spells in the forest. And once you get lost, you'll probably never find your way out. That's why they say the forest is filled with the souls of those who vanished into it, wandering for all of eternity. I see, in case of emergency, we tactically unsound around the woods. Damn. This is the part where you're supposed to get scared. Better not be thinking something devious. At all. I must merely remain aware that my presence here may mean trouble with Discord. I cannot afford to take my circumstances lightly. Oh, I'm breathing sharply, as though she just realized that as well. She slowly turns to Ultri. However, Ultri answers with a pleasant smile. You need to worry, Lord Oshitora. Your path has long been foretold. Regardless of what you may do, I swear here that we will not do anything to bring harm to you. You have my word. What's with this trust? Yes, trust. We almost just met. But she seems to trust me without question. I don't get it at all. What's she thinking? Why is she doing all this for me? And I'm sick of her thinking. Probably not gonna get me anywhere anyway. I was aware that Tusco was a land lush with greenery, but it's quite a sight. Maybe a little too lush, the pain of work land that's overgrown, and the woods there are special. It's a sacred forest that protects the Onkami Yonkai. If I recall, the word specific means the land where God sleeps. The god Utsumete, the great sinner who exiled mortals from paradise and brought us hunger and pain. A new Utsukami who seduces with sweet words, then only gives despair. This one's words seems to hit someone real hard. She looks down mutely, sadness clouding her face. Sarah, we are not in Yamato anymore. We must not blaspheme their god. I apologize, Master. Ask for your forgiveness, Lady Fumarill. They spoke while thinking. Oh no, that's not necessary. So please, you need in mind, I know beliefs can be very different between countries, or even certainly between people. I'm going to apologize for these two, Lady Ultori. Most apologies. We did not think before we spoke. We are deeply sorry. I'll be sure to insult the two of them, and we can find your heart too. I do not mind. Fumiru speaks the truth. We are all but one people, but each person is uniquely shaped by their homeland and their faith. And our God is a merciful one. I'm sure such trifles will not incur his wrath. Yeah, Hakuro is like, no, you're probably right. I've done some fucked up things. Did some fucked up wish granting. Yeah, no, that's... Do you already know? But be sure to avoid that kind of talk when anyone else is around. Yes, the people who are destination do not know your circumstances as well as Ku and I do. They may take remarks like that to heart. That's right, they have a place for the most devout of believers. Even Mother and I cannot cover for you. You say things for it like that. Considering he condemned all of humanity. To be fair, they did dissect his wife and daughter. I shall be sure to keep that in mind. You know, seeing your wife's brain in a jar, kinda. Seems like it's getting a little more lively outside and carriage seems to be calmed down. I believe we are nearly there. Nori looks at the window as though she noticed something. 110 or 100,000 pretend to deserve where they are. The only problem was how indiscriminate he was about it, but otherwise, you know, whatever. I meet Kohan's eye. She gives me an encouraging smile and nod. Open the blind and see a view completely opposite to what I saw earlier. Hey, wait, this is the same thing from Relutier day. Like, one of the very first arcs of the second game. God damn it. The first we've seen is gone. Now a wide road, as wide as Imperial Capital's main street, stretches out before us. The road is packed in many other carriages, people riding up there, and even simple pedestrians throwing inside. Shh. These people are... They are people who... All over the country, they come to pray before a great shrine. Not as much. I look around the hustle and bustle, equal to the activity in the Imperial Capital. The road is lined with shops catering to the worshippers. Tea shop. One looks like a souvenir shop. Hairpins, dolls. Oh, they even have textiles here. Might as well buy some souvenirs for the others while I'm here. That's certainly why I'm here and shake off my fearless impulse. No, that's not what I came for. I ought to leave you to go hunting for souvenirs. Master, stay close. We ask that you do not stray far from us beyond this point. We finally arrived. We have no fight. I'll get off at the carriage stop before a massive gate. Ooh! The grand shape is just beyond those gates. So beyond the part is the land where God sleeps. And what this is? Can I help but exclaim at the sight before me? Endless line of people, wide and twisted head. All the whippet worshippers gathered at the gates of the grand shrine to wait their turn. The sign is ridiculously long. Are we even gonna make it to the gate before nightfall? Perhaps we should get up and during today. Let's find a place to spend the night, and we should try again in the morning. Come on, get a small check on my word. You don't have to worry, I think. What? Well, I can ask any more questions. Come on, weave through the line of people until she reaches the front. Oh, that Kuon. Apparently realizing what Kuon's doing, a wry smile flickered across Ultori's face. What exactly is all Kuon trying to do here? Keep watching and all will be answered. If I watch, then never will happen. Kuon is almost immediately surrounded by suspicious guards. However, a few words from Kuon seems to make the sentries go pale. They rush into nearby barracks in a panic. What the? Suddenly, the sound of drums echoes across the area. The hubble dies down immediately. The visitors to the gate immediately part to the side of the road, making way. What exactly is? Appear the gates. Watch the scene, Kuon waving cheerily at us. A trap. We were too far too careless. We were among enemies. Let them just well trained. We might as well be taking care of them immediately. Stop worrying about that. But I understand your concerns. Yeah, I do not believe the ancient of Triskor will revert to such underhanded means such as an ambush. To be fair, I'm pretty sure Benui and Kuro could take Oster on any day of the week. Do you choose to believe the words of Etherno Uso Metafia? What I believe is that I trust Kuon, Fumeru, and you two. Therefore, I have nothing to worry about, correct? Correct. Doubt the people here will do anything so roundabout in the first place. Seems like you two have met a wonderful man indeed. Path between a worship place, who bow their heads deeply as we make our way forward. For the gate, Kwon stands waiting for us, a huge smile on our face. It'll get us into the grand shrine in an instant, I think. Understand your sentiment, but how can I help but feel bad for those still stuck in line? Look behind us in the mobile shrine goers, locked in place, our heads respectfully bowed. I guess that only Unkakuru is with us and all, so it's only natural. In any case, we can finally make it to the grand shrine now. Let us proceed then. Lead and I shall follow. Now Haku's doing that, give a bow on that altar, go on first. Well, what's the word of the girl? No idea what's waiting ahead, but what's already here, no point in stopping. Humble. He is quite humble. No point in stopping now. We'll proceed through the Grand Shrine, hope to be meeting us. You know what? This seems like a pretty good place to stop for the night. Now, thanks for hanging there and joining this with me. Anybody else who's watching, thank you so much. And yeah, I'm gonna post this up on my YouTube channel along with the rest of the playlist. God damn, we're in like... It seems like a very good on that. It seems like a decent stopping point before what's coming up next. I've hit 3 hours and... What's coming up next is gonna be one heck of a marathon, so, you know, look forward to it. But yeah, I call it a night. Whoop. Goddamn, 96 goddamn songs. Yes, good night. That's a good song, though. Definitely a good song. But yeah, we're gonna call it a night. Oh yeah. Good night, everybody. And thanks for watching. I'll be picking up this one next time. Whenever again. Good night.